Ahmed Khan Rahami, born in Afghanistan, was a Black Lives Matter supporter, hated the police, had filed reports that the police had not been nice to him. He is now in custody after a reported shootout. NBC News New York is reporting. We do not have details, but he supposedly is in custody. We don't know what condition. And we're going to put up on screen for TV viewers the little angel. The little angel. This had nothing to do with Islam, nothing to do with Muslims, nothing to do with ISIS, even though ISIS took credit Saturday right after it happened. And, of course, the stabbing of 9 people in rural Minnesota. Well, the man screamed Allah Akbar and asked, are you Muslim? No. That had nothing to do with Islam. And Hillary Clinton came out and lectured everyone on Sunday that this is not Islam. This is not a bombing. In fact, she says, yes, I was made aware of both bombings in New York and New Jersey. And then the CNN script, I guess, from her bosses came out. And they said, ma'am, what about his, compulsiveness? Trump saying it was a bombing. She said, it's terrible. This is the type of horrible things he does. In the same minute, 30 seconds, we have the unedited clip coming up. This is incredible. We covered this yesterday on the Sunday show. Trump was on Fox News this morning pointing it out, how disgusting and despicable and sickening these people are. I mean, this is an occupied globalist force. And have you ever thought that I was kidding around when I broke down the emails of George Soros that WikiLeaks and others have released, along with DC leaks, where he openly said, we want to destroy Europe and get rid of Europeans. We now have a TV ad from Germany saying how great it is to wear the hijab for German women. But it gets worse. We now have Swedish TV coming up, produced by the government. So is the German ad by the UN, where it says, Sweden is over. It's got subtitles. This is the end. And then a woman in a hijab looks up and says, get used to it. Quote, let me give you the exact quote. This is the new country. Sweden is old. You are gone. We are the future. This from the Swedish government officially. This is an official battle plan. It's happening. Now, you have to understand, ladies and gentlemen, that they're bringing in the most radical Muslims because they're incompatible even in their own countries, the Wahhabist. And they're now selling women wearing full burqas as a woman's right when these women are prisoners. So you've got that whole issue, and you've got the mainstream media falling on its sword in delusion, committing suicide in front of everyone politically, saying that Donald Trump is wrong to come out and say there's been bombings when it was a bombing. Being decisive is now being compulsive. Then Hillary comes out, says it's a bomb. They say, no, ma'am, you don't say that. Trump says it. Oh, you're right. He's bad for saying it's a bomb. In the same sentence, then CNN and others edit the video in the same minute and a half to have her criticizing him for saying bomb. This is actually incredible comedy. This is the most hilarious. I mean, this is very funny if it wasn't so serious. These people are crazy. This is them, of course, fresh off of telling you Hillary isn't falling down. Hillary doesn't have epilepsy. Alex Jones is a big fat liar. Matt Drudge is a big fat liar. And then a week later, she collapses in front of everybody, and the media tries to cover that up, too. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the 19th day of September, 2016. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We have seen coordinated jihadi terror attacks where we have Islamic State of Al-Qaeda claiming responsibility for the attacks, the stabbings as the lunatic Somali, 100,000 brought in just in the last decade, mainly to Minnesota, screamed Allah Akbar. He would ask, are you a Muslim? They would say, no. Allah Akbar! And attack. Just like they do in Kenya and everywhere else in the shopping mall. Are you a Muslim to your 5-year-old kid? No. Boom! Blow your brains out. Come up to your wife. Are you a Muslim? No. Boom! Shoots you right in the chest. Come right up to daddy. Get him on the ground. Are you a Muslim? No. Then they start cutting your head off real loving and real sweet. And you got Obama's family on record quarterbacking operations in Kenya. quarterbacking money by the hundreds of millions to Egypt to overthrow that country. And CNN and Anderson Cooper, 4 years ago, celebrating it, saying freedom was coming to Egypt, overthrowing our secular allies that had stabilized the country for 35 years. Betraying our allies. Again, I'm just giving you some background here. So you've got the jihad attack, which they wouldn't call a jihad attack, just like the weekly jihad attacks in London or the other Allah Akbar stabbings in Canada or Germany that are happening every few days in Belgium, in Sweden, in Germany. German women are so mind-controlled that even when members of the parliament, the Bundestag and the Reichstag, on record, when members of their Congress are raped, they come out and tell the German police, blonde-haired Germans raped me. And when they get caught, they say, I did it to protect the Muslims. That is on record. National TV in Germany airs UN ads showing women wearing hijabs that are German, saying how cool it is and how you should try it too. And now we have a new video coming up. If you're a radio listener, you must go to InfoWars.com to see this article. There's no turning back. That's a quote. Swedish TV ad says Swedes must accept multiculturalism. It shows old Swedes and basically says you're the past. And then you've got the subtitles. A Muslim woman looks up and says something new, the new country. No turning back, a woman in a hijab. And we have George Soros' own emails running the UN, running the Obama administration, running the Hillary operation, saying we're bringing these people in to break down the culture and make the Western free culture adapt to it and submit to it. Because we're so inclusive, we must bring in something uninclusive to make our people submit to this. Then the Muslims will be the client of the government. And will be put in as mayors and police chiefs, as they've been done all over Europe disproportionately. And just like London has their Islamicist mayor coming to the U.S. and lecturing us, and he's in New York today. He's in New York today. Now, think of the total and complete absolute mind control that you have a bombing in New Jersey, a bombing that injures 29 people right there in New York, trying to target the route of a fundraiser for wounded veterans in the Marine Corps. Think about how evil they are. And the media comes out Saturday. And they come out and they say, even though there were already videos of the now captured suspect sitting there hauling up the bomb. And they tell you it's not terror. And Donald Trump getting on a plane says, well, I hear some bombs have gone off. You know, this country's in a lot of trouble. We'll be investigating it. And the media comes out and attacks him, despite the fact that Hillary Rodham Clinton openly came out the same day and said the word bombing. But 1 minute later, CNN says, isn't Donald Trump wrong for calling this a bombing too early? And she says, yes, he's wrong. Full video on InfoWars.com. We're going to play those clips coming up. But this shows the abject cult level, fascist level, totalitarian level of the media, where they are in lockstep trying to deceive the American people. Here's the good news. When they come out and say that Obamacare is free and the IRS isn't going to fine you, and then, of course, it isn't free, it increases prices and you get fined, the American people wake up and remember. When they come out and tell you Hillary has no health problems, never falls down, Alex Jones is totally insane, making up out of whole cloth, claiming that she falls down and claiming she has epilepsy and brain problems. And then all these medical doctors come out and say clearly she does. And then she falls down in front of everybody 4 days after CNN, CBS, MSNBC, you name it, all in a coordinated attack. Attacked yours truly, Breitbart, and Drudge Report. And attacking the Trump sons and others, saying that we were basically completely insane, that there was no health problems whatsoever. They are falling apart in front of everyone. Ahmed Khan, how do you pronounce his last name? R-A-H-A-M-I, Rahami. Ahmed Khan Rahami has been captured. We don't have the details yet in a supposed shootout. But remember, Hillary said it's not terror and it's not a bombing. New York, New Jersey bombing suspect wounded, arrested after shootout, two officers hit. This is coming out as we speak. That's CNN. More developments. Just 10 minutes ago, we just knew that he'd been captured in a shootout. I made the obvious point, which they'd call precipitous, like Trump did, to say, I wonder if he's been wounded. Oh, he has been wounded. You know, for Trump to say, hey, bombs have gone off. Looks like it's bombs. We're learning more. Yeah, when a marathon gets bombed and another bomb goes off in New Jersey same day, it was pretty safe for Trump to say, looks like we've had some bombs. We're not sure. We're looking into it. They don't like Trump being out ahead of her 2 hours. 2 hours later, she goes, yes, I've heard of the bombs going off. They go, ma'am, we're saying it's bad that he said that. Oh, he's very horrible, yes. But wait. Now they're having to admit that there's been a terror attack and that there's probably more because there's a cell, reportedly, and five jihadists, alleged jihadists, connected to this guy have been stopped going to the airport. Getting to the airport. So we've got all this unfolding right now. And so Hillary has come out. After the break, I'm going to play the clip. And she's come out and she said Trump is a, quote, sergeant of ISIS. And it's his fault that that we were hit with terror attacks. So it wasn't a terror attack. It wasn't a bomb. And it's Trump's fault for lying. But now it's a terror attack and Trump's behind it. Hillary Clinton and the mainstream media officially are worse than Baghdad Bob. Remember the spokesman for the defense ministry in Iraq? There would be planes and tanks and wars going on 2 miles behind him, explosions going off, and he'd be on TV in Baghdad going, we have routed the Americans, kicked them out of Baghdad. In fact, we've kicked them back into Kuwait. We've kicked them back into Jordan. They're not even in the country. We have annihilated them. A jet flies by. Then he's like, oh, excuse me. As I said, Americans are totally defeated. We must stop press conference now. Remember Baghdad Bob? Our media is more ridiculous than Baghdad Bob. It isn't a bombing. It isn't terror. Donald Trump's horrible. And it's a terror attack. And it's Donald Trump's fault. I mean, these people, Hillary Clinton looks like she's dead. She can barely get upstairs. It's in all the emails that she's got Parkinson's medication and that years ago she could barely walk. Everybody's worried about her. It's all come out. The Secret Service told us she falls down more than once an hour. We said, how often? Just sometimes every 15, 20 minutes. It's bad. They've got to keep her so drugged up that she doesn't have seizures, but she then looks drugged up and can barely talk. I mean, she looks so sleepy and so tired in her, quote, you know, couple press interviews she did Saturday and Sunday about the bombings, that she was just like,
Trump bombings, excuse me.
I mean, she's on so much seizure medication, she can't open her eyeballs up. And the media sits there and goes, Alex Jones is a kook. Alex Jones is a kook. Yeah. Because we have the sources, we have the evidence, we have the facts, we have all the information. I'm going to skip this break. Now, let's just start walking through all of this. We have Ahmed Khan Rahim. Did I pronounce that right? Rahami. Ahmad Khan Rahami. Another little sweetie pie from Afghanistan. And we have this other sweetie pie. We'll put his face and name up. From Somalia. And by the way, if you go to Minnesota, because that's where the GCN network's based, and you go to Minneapolis, St. Paul, you think you're in the Horn of Africa. You think you're in Somalia. I've never seen one cab driver that isn't Somali. And I'm not here to attack Somalis. But the point is that Somalia is probably the most terrorist country on earth. Okay? And so we now have the Minnesota mall stabbings might realize worse fears of local Somalis. Oh, my gosh. There's only been a bunch of terror attacks in Minnesota by Somalis, stabbing, killing, and bombing people. But it just gets covered up. And it's the craziest stuff you've ever seen going on. You can't go to Somalia if you're an American. They'll kill you in a second. It's the same thing over and over again. These countries, if you're not a hardcore Sunni Wahhabist, you are dead within about 5 minutes in Somalia or kidnapped. You understand? No one can get in. Not the press, not special forces, not anybody. You go to Somalia, you are dead. Oh, and by the way, a lot of you are going to think, oh, well, I'm sure we're letting Christians or refugees in from Somalia. No, I have a mainstream news article today admitting that 99% of the Somalis coming in are Muslims. And you know why? There isn't 1% Christian in Somalia. Because the Muslims don't let you be Christian. A couple hundred years ago, it was Christian. Not anymore, because they killed everybody or sold them into slavery. Because Muslims are so sweet and so good and so loving. And so these terror attacks, because we can now say they're a terror attack. Hillary has now said it. And these bombing attacks, we can now say it, because Hillary now said it today, has nothing to do with Islam. We can't say that now. I mean, I'm so angry. I'm sweating, folks. I am just totally upset about what's happening. But now, the media can come out today. The police and the FBI today said, okay, it is an act of terrorism in New York and New Jersey. Days after, ISIS took responsibility. So there's the headline. We'll put it back on screen for TV viewers. Explosive language, The Observer. Call the New York bombing terrorism already. Oh my gosh, that scene is right-wing and radical yesterday. To have the New York Observer come out and say, call it terrorism. Oh my gosh, how bold, when you've got Afghans that are refugees and you've got Somalis that are, quote, refugees, and they're running around screaming Allah Akbar, killing and bombing people and stabbing them. Oh my gosh, it's so radical to call it terrorism or a bombing or Muslim. These people are worse than Baghdad Bob. In fact, I'm going to do a piece today after the show where I'm going to show clips of Baghdad Bob. We have the DVD back there somewhere of his most ridiculous statements. And then show our media, which I'm telling you, out Baghdad Bob's Baghdad Bob. Now, the first thing I want to do here, out of literally dozens of clips we've got, is before we show you the Swedish government saying, you will not be white or Christian anymore, you will be Muslim. The new Sweden is a woman with a hijab. You understand? That's who Sweden is now, cupcake. Because the fetish by the left is to commit suicide of the West. It's a sacrifice. They get off on it. It's like, you know, devil worshippers wanting to grab a little kid out of their backyard and go torture him and cut their heart out to Satan. That's what they like to do. They like to hurt things. They like to overthrow things. They like to bring in backward things. They like to bring in oppressive things. They like to finance sexual mutilation. And Uma Abedin's mother is the foremost pusher of women's having their genitals cut off in the world and writes books on it. And then we cover it and they have leftist media make fun of us and say, so what? Because they're not left. They're sick, degenerate filth that want to bring this country down like kamikazes. But let's go now to Trump coming out, talking about how disgusting CNN is and breaking down the fact that these people are like from another planet. Here it is.
CNN is disgusting and they're disgraceful. I watch it all. I watch all of the folks. And sometimes Fox actually doesn't treat me well also, by the way, but that's okay. You people do, that's all.
We're fair and balanced.
But you're fair and balanced, I agree. But I watch CNN, and I look at what's happened. How about Bill Clinton's statement last week, where he talked about her sickness, that it says something that happens all the time, or something.
Frequently.
And then they said, he said, oh, I meant it only happened. In other words, she gets sick all the time, or frequently. And then he goes, oh, I mean, just every once in a while.
Right, and they edited it out.
They took it out. Do you think if that happened to me, do you think they take it out? They not only don't take it out, it feels like they add things. I mean, these people are the most dishonest people. CNN is so disgusting and dishonest, and I watch it. It is so unfair. They call it the Clinton News Network. If you saw her in the back of the plane, and she used the words bombs also, by the way, and that's true. I heard, I didn't see it, but I heard I was criticized for calling it correctly. What I said was exactly correct. I should be a newscaster because I called it before the news.
Yeah, you should be president of the United States. You've got all the stamina, all the smarts, everything we need for leadership. Not, you don't want to sell the country out. You want to let us be competitive. You're not out to get the country. You don't want to mount our head on the wall. You're an American. He's an American. He wants to bring back the American system. Doesn't mean he's perfect. Now, let's expand on this now. Let's go ahead. Now, this is a shorter clip because we played the minute and a half clip yesterday where she comes out and says, I heard about the bombs going off in New York and New Jersey and blah, blah, blah. And then CNN goes like a minute later. Now, Trump was precipitous and came out and said it was a bomb before we knew. They were still not calling it a bomb at that time. She goes, well, that's horrible. See, that's how bad he is. But then CNN after that would edit out the first part so she wouldn't look like a psychologically kleptocratic deceiver on par with the devil who tells a lie when the truth would suit him better. Let's play the clip.
I've been briefed about the bombings in New York and New Jersey and the attack in Minnesota. Obviously, we need to do everything we can to support our first responders.
Okay, so that's what she originally said that they cut out of the next clip where she criticizes Trump in the same minute and a half. Everybody's already seen that. Now let's go to the edited clip where they show her on the same plane in the same minute and a half criticizing Trump. Here it is.
Obviously, we need to do everything we can to support our first responders, also to pray for the victims. We have to let this investigation unfold. We've been in touch with various officials, including the mayor's office in New York, to learn what they are discovering as they conduct this investigation. And I'll have more to say about it when we actually know some facts.
Secretary, do you have any reaction to the fact that Donald Trump, immediately upon taking the stage tonight, called the explosion in New York a bomb and pulled that to the ground?
Well, I think it's important to know the facts about any incident like this. That's why it's critical to support the first responders, the investigators who are looking into it, trying to determine what did happen. I think it's always wiser to wait until you have information before making conclusions.
Okay, so on the timeline, we have it all DVR'd. 5 minutes before, CNN put that out and said moments ago. They have her live talking to a few members of the press from her airplane, barely able to stand up, looking like she's on massive amounts of depressants so she doesn't have more seizures. Okay? That's just a side issue. And she says, well, I heard about the bombs going off in New York and New Jersey, then goes into that whole spiel you just heard, then criticizes Trump. A few minutes later, they re-air the clip and cut the front part off. Now, since Trump mentioned Bill Clinton and the fact that he was on national news, CBS, and other channels, talking about how Hillary, you know, falls down all the time. Now, Hillary's collapsed many times. Then he catches himself and goes, I mean, you know, hardly ever, but over time has done it. They edit that out. So here's Bill Clinton.
When you look at that collapse, that video that was taken, you wonder if it's not more serious.
No,
than dehydration.
She's been, well, if it is, it's a mystery to me and all of her doctors, because frequently, not frequently, that's not, rarely, but on more than one occasion over the last many, many years, the same sort of things happened to her when she just got severely dehydrated.
Here's the edited piece. So there you go. And unfortunately, we don't have enough time every day, and neither do you, to just go through all their all their different designs, all their deceptions, all the things they're doing. But I've got stacks of clips here where they're editing, where they're censoring, where they're deceiving, where they're blocking, where they're controlling, and they're doing it more and more and more. Here's the good news. The American people are now watching and are now finally aware of this, so it's not going well. We've got massive coverage of the latest attacks, the manhunt, the fact that the supposed mastermind of all of this, the alleged mastermind, Ahmed Khan Rahami, has been shot twice, and is wounded. Two police officers have also been wounded. That's being reported. The problem is CNN's reporting it, so you never know. But it's being reported by other news outlets, so it may be true, but only because they're getting the information from locals and then being forced to report it. It's a scary thing to know the type of things that CNN's been caught doing when they're in control of a story and are the ones running the whole show. Now, when we come back, I want to get into the Islamification of this country and the world and the master plan behind it. I want to play the ads that are airing in Sweden and Germany, basically saying your time is over, convert to Islam, submit to it. That is the plan. with the jihadi mayor of London here shaking his fist at us in New York today. Again, it's all part of rubbing our noses in it, dominating, squatting on top of us, and basically trying to make us submit to their tyranny. We've got a lot of other key clips. Michael Savage is joining us again. Wow, twice in 2 weeks. And a lot more. Our reporters are in New York. But quite frankly, I probably shouldn't even announce this or launch this today, but I am. We spent a lot of money on it. It's a free app. In about 2 months, part two will be added to the app, where it's going to have even more incredible features, but it's got a bunch of them right now. We've got an app that we came out with about 5 years ago that's just an audio app that over 1 million people have downloaded for free. It's the Apple app. There's a bunch of other apps that are out there that other people have made that are Droid apps that are not ours. But I love getting all the customer service emails and calls about everybody else's apps that aren't ours. That's fine. I don't care. I'm not complaining. But we have made InfoWars Live app. And I'm getting right back into the terror attacks and the bombings and the stabbings and all the other jihad fun that's going on because we dare give these people welfare and bring them here and just give them everything for free and, you know, and then have our leftist media piss all over us. Excuse me, God. I'm just so angry right now. I'm really so fundamentally angry with the media, how deceptive they are, what traitors they are, how low they are. Hillary, all of you are just sickening, horrible people. You are just, you have to work to be such scum. And I'm so sick of you, and I'm so sick of some of the general public that still sits there. It's like that Perino lady during a Bush press conference or during one of those White House press conferences. She was sitting there, and they said, is it true the dollar's down? And that's why oil prices are blah, blah, blah. I mean, you don't need to ask her if that was the case. You could just go do basic economics and know it. But it's like, it's not a terror bombing till they say. It's not a Muslim till they say. It's not a crime till they say. For at least 5 years, and we've had the witnesses on, in Homeland Security, they're not allowed to call a terror attack a terror attack. They're not allowed to call a mosque a mosque. They're not allowed to call a Muslim a Muslim. They're not allowed to call an Al-Qaeda person or an ISIS person by their name under federal regulations, or they get reprimanded or fired. I mean, we've had the whistleblowers on. We ought to have them back on. Imagine that. This is the level of control. You think they're just telling us don't use the word Muslim or bomb or terror attack? That's what the FBI is told. That's what Customs is told. That's what it is to live in a mind control country where they tell you what language to use. Because the sickening globalists and George Soros are allied with radical Islam and are taking over 23 countries as we speak. Taking them over. The West is only in a destabilization program right now. We aren't to that point yet. But in Sweden and Germany and France, they're putting ads on saying, you are demoralized, you are dead, you are over, give up to the hijab, give up to Muhammad and Allah. Allah Akbar, we're going to stab your daughter at the mall. We're going to stab your wife, your son. We're going to stab you with a butcher knife. And then the police chief's going to get up and say, we love our Somalis. We love our Muslims. Oh, they're so good. Oh, they're so sweet. I was watching Fox News as I worked out this morning, and they had the police chief on making excuses from that town in Minnesota. And they had the Fox News host, this is the Fair and Balanced channel, going, Donald Trump really stepped in at this time. He said it was a bombing before it had officially been called a bombing, and Hillary's on him, and she's got some really good points. Fox is where MSNBC was 2 or 3 years ago. Now MSNBC is foam at the mouth deception and is so filled with hate of you and your family, they can't even control it. I mean, you look at the body language of Rachel Maddow. She is in a sport, a death sport. She wants to conquer you. She hates Christians. They had a former top diplomat come out last week and say, who hadn't even really been a Christian. He says, man, I'm not even a right winger or a big Christian. I'm telling you, we got to pull the article. We don't have that guy on. He said, we're taking Russia down because they're Christian, period. Hollywood runs the U.S. and they hate Christians. I mean, I'm telling you, people, this is sick. The leftists hate Christians. so much that they will literally burn this country down if they need to get full control. It's like George Soros in his emails is talking about how to bring Israel down. You can say what you want about Israel. Israel's done some oppression, done some bad things, but they're fighting people that want them exterminated. What do you expect? Then there's the argument, well, you know, Israel didn't have that area for 1,000 years. Okay, but I mean, the Jews were in the Middle East at one point. Then they'll argue, oh, there's no Jews. Those aren't real Jews. Then they do the DNA test and test the bones. It's the same damn people, you know, mixed with Europeans. It doesn't even matter. I've never even been some Israel firster. But that's back when the globalists were trying to stir up the Middle East. I was trying to stop this clash of civilizations. They've done it. They've radicalized the Muslims. They've blown the doors open. The borders are open. The Mediterranean's open. Georgia's open. Albania's open. Macedonia's open. Turkey's open. Millions are pouring in, people of the very worst type that kill each other. Do you understand? It's an attack. It's red level. It doesn't matter now. You got to choose sides at this point. The globalists have overrun us. It's all, there's not 100,000 people they brought in. They brought in 100,000 Somalis in the last year or two. They're now admitting that in the news. I told you it's not 100,000 total. It's hundreds of thousands per country. It's millions. They're everywhere. You got to warn people. You understand? I don't fundamentally hate Muslims and want to kill them. I tried to stop those wars, to contain it and try to reform those countries with earlier policies our government had under Eisenhower. But those policies to stabilize the Middle East, put women in college, and take them out of the dark ages have been blown wide open by the neocons and the Democrats and George Soros. They are putting the very worst, bloodthirsty, creepy weirdo dudes in white pajamas that have sex slaves in control with trillions of dollars. And I will be, you know what? I will go to hell before I sit here and I watch this country and the world turned over to these savages. I'm done. I'm pissed. And I'm not putting up with it anymore. Let me tell you something, you filthy traitors in the government. You pieces of crap. You are the most degenerate, twisted, mentally ill people I've ever seen, wanting to gang rape this republic and this country and the West that has been the literal cornerstone, the absolute jewel in the crown of free Western Renaissance societies and the very best literature, music, technology, science, medicine, culture the world's ever seen. You Satanists want to sacrifice the West. You want to kill the beautiful goddess that is the West. You people are enemies, and we're going to get your asses, and we know what you're up to, and we're coming for you. So I've had enough of these people. Okay, so I've been containing this for the last week. That's why I've been in here sweating, getting pissed. Because I can't handle it anymore. It is an absolute fact that they're coming for all of us, okay? And I have just come to that realization, and I am so pissed at the filth that runs our government, and I'm even more pissed at the collaborators in our media and our military and our police forces and in the general population that can't see a total takeover when it's staring you in your eyeballs. It's not like it's some threat coming from 1,000 miles away. It's not like it's over the hill and around the dale. It's here. Let me start over. Excuse me. We have launched an information warfare against the globalists trying to wake people up. We've proven we know exactly what their battle plans are, and hackers have gotten all their information, and it's exactly what we told you they were doing, because most of these globalists have already written books and brag about 95% of what they're doing. We've just got the other 5% of what they're planning, and it just completes our worst nightmares. So there's no going back. There's no discussion of this. We all know the truth now. And you either choose the side of liberty and freedom, or you choose the side of the New World Order, allied with the stinking, filthy, third world woman raping, ass wiping with their... I may have to go off air, okay? See, I've been holding this back, not blowing up on air for a few weeks. I'm sure you've noticed. I've been trying to control myself, trying to be professional about this. But at a certain point, I just am just really getting pissed. Just excuse me. I'm pissed about the attack on language, the attack on reality, the attack on common sense. I am so sick of these people. But I'll tell you the good news. That lying witch, Hillary Clinton, is on her last legs. And so thank you, God. Thank you for the hand of doom coming against her. I don't wish her any harm, but I wish you to have judgment on Hillary Clinton. I want everyone to pray for judgment on Hillary Clinton. Let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, please help us to be strong and help us to protect the innocents. And please help us to rebuild this nation. And we repent for how evil we've been. But please, 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 please don't put us into the hands of these people, for God's sakes. Please. I know we've killed 50 million babies. We're so horrible. But my God, this country's trying to wake up. Will you just please let us not be taken control of by the filth of the planet? Amen. Oh, my God. Let me tell all the scum and all the leftists, you're going to lose all your jobs soon. The whole mainstream media is dying. We're going to be in a huge depression. You're going to be living in your mother's basements. And I hope your little fake liberal culture you've got that's totally fascist and satanic, I hope it keeps you warm at night, because that's all you're going to have and it's all you're ever going to have. Okay? I just hope you understand that. Now, get back to what I was saying. We have, ladies and gentlemen, a new app that has a lot of great features. And you go to Infowars.com/app to get it for free. And it's on Android. It's on Apple. It's a very, very nice app. It's totally free. And it sends you news alerts. And it's got videos and the daytime show and select clips of the nightly show and special reports and a lot of other exclusive things. And it's absolutely free at Infowars.com. We have links to it free there, and Infowars.com/app. And I've never done a pop-up in 19 years of the Infowars website. Never done an app or a pop-up is what I meant to say. But we're going to have a pop-up popping up later today. If you are on a smartphone, if you are one of these little globalist devices that most people have already gone to, then a pop-up will pop up for you to be able to go and get it free. Just X out of it if you don't want to. That's another way to get the free app. Let me go ahead and read you about the app here before I have a heart attack. The new free app from InfoWars. Stay informed and up to date with InfoWars Live, your top source for independent alternative news. Breaking news alerts. Watch the Alex Jones Show live in HD from your phone or tablet. Get the latest headline news free from the distortions of the enemy, filth, garbage media that absolutely hates you and your family. I mean, they do. You understand? They hate you. They hate you. Get that through your head. This isn't rhetoric. They hate you. They hate God. We're not just fighting regular enemies here, folks. Every story is organized by category so you can find the information you want when you want it. Share news with your friends. It's all formatted to phones and save stories for later viewing. This app also features radio mode, so you can listen to the Alex Jones Show while you're on the run. You can download the app and join us for the fight to save humanity, which this is. It's not rhetoric. Available now for free at both the Apple App Store and the Android Play Store. Search for InfoWars Live. InfoWars Live. That's the name of the app. Or go to InfoWars.com/app for the direct links. Please share. This is the key. Key. That means key. Share this app now with all your family and friends. The future of the Republic depends on it. All right. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. What puts me over the edge is watching Hillary Clinton get up there and say, yeah, I know about the bombings. And then they go, well, what about Donald Trump calling it a bombing? And she goes, well, that's horrible. And the fact that the media is so mind-controlled, they go along with that and actually are trying to cue her in to do that, shows you how trashy these people are. But it gets worse. Then I have to sit there every day and watch UN-sponsored and other ads, and I know who's behind it, Peter Sutherland, George Soros. We have their emails. We have their operations. They admit they want to overthrow us. They admit they want to make us poor. They hate us. They're just horrible demons connected to every form of evil you can imagine. And now they come out and they run all these different ads saying there's no turning back. Swedish TV ad says Swedes must accept multiculturalism. There's no going back. It's called closing your borders and creating a deportation squad. But see, they're bringing in the client groups, ladies and gentlemen, with leftists to then outvote and control and then instill the, quote, minorities with anti-Western racism. It's not that these people are bad inherently. If they were educated, but they've been re-educated. They've already come out of an authoritarian system, so they will comply immediately with the new tyranny. This is an alliance. This is a takeover. The article's on Infowars.com, and it ties into all the other videos we've been playing lately with, oh, I wear the hijab, I'm German woman, I'm like Turkish now, brought to you by the United Nations. This is how they're pushing all this garbage. Let's go ahead and play this clip without our bug so I can read the subtitles, please. I'm going to play this clip. This is from Swedish government-funded ad. Okay, this is this. And imagine what they're teaching kids if you think this is bad. Here it is with a key quote at the end about how this is the, quote, new country. Let's go ahead and go to it.
Det finns ingen väg tillbaka.
Sverige blir aldrig.
There's no way back, Sweden. Will never be what it was. Let's start over again. I want to start over again because I have people talking to my head, and I'm sorry. I got to start over again. And the crew was giving me a note, and I want to start over. Let's play the ad. Here we go.
Det finns ingen väg tillbaka.
There's no way back. Sweden will never be what it was once. Europe is changing, and Sweden is needing a safe space for people to live in. Now we must look forward and find a way to live side by side. Now we must look forward. It's time to realize that new Swedes will claim their space and bring their culture, language, and habits, and it's time to see that as a positive force. To be Swedish must be more than skin color and place of birth. This must be you and everybody together. That means submitting. No culture. It's not only new Swedes that need to integrate. Everyone needs to integrate, even established Swedes. You must immigrate to them. Immigration is about finding mutual understanding. Let's create a future that is based on equal parts, reality, and belief in the future. Let's build a country where we put hate and fear aside. We all have the new country within us, in our worldview, thoughts, and actions. It's time to react and create a country together that is proud, inclusive, and sustainable. It's time to create something new, the new country. Okay? And then the something new is a woman in a hijab. Because you're bad fundamentally, you have to create a safe space. This is all social justice warrior nomenclature from the UN. And this is saying you must submit, Sweden. You've only taken in, what, a million Muslims the last few years. They're only record rapes. The police are ordered to cover it up. They're only, you know, doing all this stuff. But it's okay because you need to submit to it and you need to accept it. And they have accepted it. So the answer is more, 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 more. And when they bomb you, it's not a bombing. When they stab you screaming Allah Akbar, well, you better put a hijab on and submit to them. This, how do you bring down national sovereignty? How do you do this if you're mega banks offshore? You bring in people that are incompatible for total divide and conquer. I'll admit, though, it's so bold, it makes my head spin. We'll be back. Stay with us. I've been trying to control myself, but when I see actual scientific tyranny taking place, and I have the battle plans, I have the emails of the multinationals to flood Europe and the U.S. and Canada and Australia and collapse us, and they admit to collapse us and make us poor, and they're bringing in the most intolerant, savage, backward people from the Middle East and Africa. I mean, it's a fact, folks, where women are absolute slaves in North Africa and Western Africa in certain areas. And the countries where they're not, like Kenya, our president is working with the Muslims to take over. There are many countries in Africa where women are in charge of many areas. I mean, it's not like I'm kissing women's asses. I have a mother. I have daughters. It fundamentally pisses me off. At a primitive level, I'm primitive too. I mean, we're showing images for TV viewers of Paris with the North Africans and the Somalis and all the rest of it. I mean, it's millions and millions and millions and millions and millions more than they're saying. Okay? It is so bad, people. It is so out of control. And I've got stacks of videos here where Minneapolis Muslims prefer Sharia, want blasphemy laws in the U.S., and we just played Swedish TV says Swedes must accept multiculturalism. I have other clips where, you know, the Imam of Jerusalem says Europe is weak and the blonde hair, blue eyes are bad. We take their women and we will take our their governments are under our control. I mean, it's even like a cartoon, like sound like Klingons. Black flack and blog, black and it's like, oh, liberal, it's not a bombing, it's not an Allah Akbar stabbing at the mall. And it's our government covering it up and the plan and the admissions of all this. Like, let's go out to break with Amy Horowitz, interviews Muslims in Minneapolis, and Amy finds a few common threads in the unanimous opposition to the freedom of speech and support for criminalizing criticism of Islam by a penalty of death for those who insult Muhammad. So, well, I'm not insulting Muhammad, but I'm going to tell you something right now. We're told Russia is infiltrating America. No, Russia's being destroyed by the same globalists destroying us. Russia's battling Orthodox and radical Islam, and God bless Russia. Russia isn't doing anything to this country. George Soros, the Democratic Party, Hollywood, Goldman Sachs, the big mega banks, they're the ones gang raping this country. And if you work at J.P. Morgan or Goldman Sachs, I'm not attacking you as a person, but go look at who funds all this, and that's your bosses. Do you really stand for that? You ought to start giving money to the opposition politically if you work there to balance out what you've done. Oh, I forgot. Goldman Sachs just banned giving to state candidates. Basically, Republicans. We'll play this clip coming up before Michael Savage joins us, because I've got to end this hour, and then I'll play more. But I did blow up earlier. That's real. I shouldn't do that. I have tens of millions of listeners. The media takes it out of context when I do, so I try not to do it because it's probably not helpful. But I'm going to be honest with you. It's better than me doing it at home or on the highway, which where I don't do it. Okay, because those things don't piss me off. Somebody cut me off, I don't care. You know, dropping something on my toe, I don't get mad. When I sit here and I watch the political surrender and sell out of this republic, and then I watch the traitors that are doing it saying we're the traitors, and lying about Donald Trump, and lying about who we are, saying we're the intolerant racist, when they're bringing in the most radical Muslims you can imagine, it makes me fundamentally hate their guts at a survival level. It's beyond hatred. It's just an energy that says, oh, we're going to beat you. The giant is rising. Get the free app now. Now, Infowars.com app. Get it. It's a war. Rise up. It's a war. When Hillary tells you not to use the word bomb or terrorism, when it's clearly that, it's to demoralize you. It's to break your will. Michael Savage is coming up, but first a key report on the weaponized system Hillary's using.
My running mate. We're described in the most deplorable of terms.
And that did help me reconnect with what this whole campaign is about. People like me, we're lucky.
It will be abundantly clear soon, you great big basket of deplorables.
I want the entire pool scrubbed, sterilized, and disinfected. It's no big deal.
You can put half of Trump's supporters into what I call the basket of deplorables.
It is said that the people are revolting.
You said it. They stink on ice.
No, Your Majesty, this is a very serious problem. The peasants feel you have no regard for them.
What? I have no regard for the peasants. They are my people. I am their sovereign. I love them. Oh! Drifting to the left.
This is a call to all American citizens. This is our America. And your very citizenship refuses that you be divided.
Ideological subversion is the process which is legitimate, overt, and open. You can see it with your own eyes. All you have to do, all American mass media has to do, is to unplug their bananas from their ears, open up their eyes, and they can see it. The demoralization process in the United States is basically completed already. Most of it is done by Americans to Americans, thanks to lack of moral standards. A person who was demoralized is unable to assess true information. The facts tell nothing to him. Even if I shower him with information, with authentic proof, with documents, with pictures.
Trump is racist.
Even if I take him by force to the Soviet Union and show him concentration camp, he will refuse to believe it until he is going to receive a kick in his fat bottom. If you start right now, here, this minute, you start educating new generation of Americans, it will still take you 15 to 20 years to turn the tide of ideological perception of reality back to normalcy and patriotism. The next stage is destabilization. This time, subverter does not care about your ideas and the patterns of your consumption, and it takes only from 2 to 5 years to destabilize a nation. What matters is essentials. Economy, foreign relations, defense systems. The influence of Marxist-Leninist ideas in the United States is absolutely fantastic. The next stage, of course, is crisis. It may take only up to 6 weeks to bring a country to the verge of crisis. And after crisis, with a violent change of power, structure, and economy, you have so-called the period of normalization. It may last indefinitely. This is what will happen in the United States if you allow all these schmucks to bring the country to crisis, to promise people all kind of goodies and the paradise on earth, to destabilize your economy, to eliminate the principle of free market competition, and to put a big brother government in Washington, D.C. Most of the American politicians, media, and educational system trains another generation of people who think they are living at a peacetime. False. The United States is in a state of war, undeclared total war against the basic principles and the foundations of this system. The time bomb is ticking with every second. The disaster is coming closer and closer. Unlike myself, you will have nowhere to defect to. Unless you want to live in Antarctica with penguins. This is it. This is the last country of freedom and possibility.
Free your mind as it was intended. The left will preach to you terms of Islamophobia, fear-mongering, and bigotry, preying on your 21st century demoralized perspective, normalizing it as the gospel truth, while destabilizing your neighborhood with one crisis after another. Now more than ever, you great big basket of deplorables, you must recollect your own individualism and hold strong to the truth like a mast in a raging tempest. The days of sloth and neglect are waning. John Bound for Infowars.com.
And I gotta tell you, one of the chief deplorables, Michael Savage, joins us straight away. Dr. Michael Savage, and many times he's been on the broadcast, usually just a few times a year, but he's been coming on for many years, says, Alex, you're getting me too worked up. I'm gonna lose my voice. I'm yelling. Earlier, I really got mad. And I started screaming, and my voice is gone. So I'm in trouble here. So you'll have less interruptions the next 30 minutes with Dr. Savage than you normally get because I'm so angry. He was just bringing up during the break the head of the Green Party in the Bundestag in Germany, that's their Congress, saying, thank God we're bringing in nothing but Muslims because, you know, Germans are basically bad. We're getting rid of you. Sweden's running a TV ad saying there's no turning back. Swedish TV ad says Swedes must accept multiculturalism. I played the ad last hour and played again. This just illustrates our governments are consciously turning us over to Islam. And I'll be honest, with three terror attacks, the stabbing, the two bombings, Hillary for days, you know, saying Trump's wrong for saying bombing, wrong for saying terror. It's like seeing a blue sky, you know, wrong for saying blue sky. Then being forced to now come out and say, and I have the clip, that Trump is behind it. It's his fault because he wasn't nice to ISIS because he criticized him. This is the collapse of the mainstream media's credibility. My problem is, they're still running the country, but shows Trump has turned the tide ahead in a bunch of polls. There's so much to cover with Dr. Savage. This reported bomber was shot by the police. He's still alive. We'll roll some video for TV viewers of him being taken out on a stretcher. Two police officers were shot. This guy last year had been bitching about police and was involved with Black Lives Matter. So this is a social justice warrior allied obviously with his home religion of Islam, another visitor to the country, another invader, just like the Somali stabbing people screaming Allah Akbar. So Dr. Savage, you've got the floor, the new book, Scorched Earth, Restoring the Country After Obama, Michael Savage, number one New York Times bestseller in bookstores everywhere. What do we do once we get the country back? We'll talk about that in part two. But first, sir, the terror attacks obviously are front and center.
Well, the denial to begin with. The minute it happened, we knew it was an Islamic attack. Everyone did. I mean, let's say this. The first instinct of the Marine Corps-run bombing, Muslim pipe bomb. That was my first reaction. I was right. Second attack, New York, dumpster bombing, Muslim. I was right. How many more attacks have to happen from Muslims till we realize that it's not happening in a vacuum and it's not happening because of evil Donald Trump or because of Michael Savage or Alex Jones? You know, on my Facebook, I get this from the idiots, the liberals. They say, you know, if we didn't provoke them, if we didn't put them down, if we didn't demonize them, they wouldn't do it. And I have to patiently say, study your history. Islam has been at war with the world for 1,400 years. They don't learn that at Harvard. They don't learn that at Yale. They don't learn anything. So they don't know that Islam is a warlike, militant, political machine. And they've used the First Amendment, freedom of religion, to infiltrate and conquer every nation they've ever entered. In this country, for example, I was thinking about that this morning at dawn, Alex. I had an amazing sunrise this morning on San Francisco Bay. It looked like fire. I put it up on my Facebook page. It was one of those fire sunrises. The whole world looked like it lit up like something had hit the earth. It was burning. And all I could think about was how, not the Trojan horse metaphor, but specifically freedom of religion. And I said, wait a minute. There are limitations on freedom of speech, aren't there? In other words, you can't yell, kill this or kill that. You'd be taken off the air in 1 second and probably arrested. I have limitations. I have an internal auditor in my head, an internal censor. I don't say certain things because I know that I wouldn't last in the business for 22 years. I'd lose show, advertisers, you name it. So who says that religion should be protected 100% by the First Amendment? For example, what if psychos wake up one day, as they have, and they say they're a witch and they're a religion? Well, then, hey, you got warlocks now practicing witchcraft in the army. This is showing you how sick the country has become. Fine. Well, now let's say someone comes up with a religion and says, my religion says you can kill anyone who's not like us. Is that a religion? Sure. You got the protection of your religion. How about I can rape young children? Sure. It's a religion. No, it isn't. So in other words, if a religion woke up or created or someone created a religion of child molesting, everyone say, I'm sorry, that's not a religion. If religion said you can kill anyone who's not like you, they said that's not a religion. Really? Well, look into Islam. It says kill the infidel in about 73 different places. If you find the infidel, slash his throat. Kill the Jew, kill the Christian, kill the apostate. So I'm saying right now what moderate Muslims are saying. And I've had some of these people on, mainly they're women, by the way. I've often said, Alex, only the Muslim women can save us from these animals. It's the Muslim women who have to save us from these throwback animals. All the Ahmeds of the world, like the one in New Jersey who claimed the racial discrimination. Didn't you see that one earlier? He sued the town and the police because they dared say that the chicken stand that his whole family was running was causing disturbances. So he got probably the geniuses from NYU Law School. And they sued the police in the little town in New Jersey for racism. You see, everything's racism. That's called the abuse of the First Amendment. Get it? So I'm going back to my primary point. Why should everything in a religious book be permitted in the United States of America?
Why are we bringing people from countries that are in perpetual war, the most radical Muslim countries with these Sunnis and Wahhabists, where they're constantly just killing themselves, killing their wives and daughters, pouring acid on each other's faces? They're clearly lunatics. They're clearly under a 1,400-year cult. And so we shouldn't be bringing people here from the region of cult crazies.
Well, it all goes back to Barack Obama. We have a list. You probably have it. You have the greatest information in the business of how many Muslims have come in under Obama Clinton. She was Secretary of State. I think the number was something like 681,000 Muslims have been brought in under Hillary Clinton. Now, how many of them? I keep hearing most of them are peaceful. Fine. Okay, most of them are peaceful. So what is it, 1% are radicals? What's 1% of 700,000 rounded off?
A lot of people.
Oh, what, 10? Do the math faster. You should do it in the fifth grade. 700,000, 10% of 70,000. 1% of 7,000. So about 7,000 of them are now, 7,000 radicals they brought in. So it's no way, Savage, no, it's not 1% of Muslims are radical. No, it's 0.1%. Arkansas, it's not 7,000. It's only 700. So they brought in 700 more terrorists. No, Savage, it's not 0.1%. It's 0.01%. All right, so it's not 70, it's 7. You see what I'm saying? But you still.
But we know the numbers. This latest group, decades ago, it was heretics. It was people that did actually want to live in a freer country in most cases who are fleeing Islam and were just Islamic with their roots. I've studied it. I know you've studied it. I've had scholars on. Now it's the worst third world areas that they're coming out of where they're constantly killing each other. It's a bunch of Sunnis who invaded Syria, got their butt kicked, and now are coming through Turkey into Europe, into the United States. Interpol admits, as you know, Dr. Savage, 80% are military-age men. And when they do polls in Europe, upwards of 35% say they will support jihad and suicide bombing. Now, so 35% are terrorists.
All right, so you have a higher number than I do. I'm a liberal on that, Alec. You're the conservative. I'm saying only 1%, but the point I'm making is quite clear. Bring none of them in. Under Secretary Clinton, U.S. permanently resettled 31,000. 100,000 Somali migrants. Thus, you know, the nice folks from Somalia, 80% of whom are still on welfare 15 years later.
That's right.
31,000 Somalis. Wait, it gets even better. Between 09 and 13, while Hillary Clinton was served as Secretary of Hate, the U.S. permanently resettled 31,000 Somali migrants. We got that figure, right? During Clinton's time as Secretary of State, the U.S. resettled 680,000 migrants from Muslim nations. So when I say scorched earth, Alex, I am talking about a scorched earth policy of Obama and Clinton. It's not in a vacuum. How could people not know this? You played a tape earlier of the former KGB agent. The brainwashing is overwhelming. The people are dumb. If you say anything like this, racist, thisist, thatist, it's the Communist Party USA in cahoots with the progressives. Their goal is to blow America up and remake it in their image. You know, I had a nightmare vision the other night. I said, wait, could it be as bad as some of the conspiracists say that Obama is actually a front for the Muslim Brotherhood and that the FBI, which is now in total denial about what's going on in the country and has been for a while, the Federal Bureau of Islam, is it now the Federal Bureau of Islamization, Alex? Is that what it's become?
Dr. Savage, I would hear you 15 years ago on the radio and think this guy's really smart, but claiming that, you know, Islam wants to take over, it can't, we won't put up with it. Now you were been proven totally right, and they are running TV ads in every major European country saying you must submit to Islam. It is the new culture. I mean, I have ads that I aired put out by the German and Swedish government that I aired last hour where they say you no longer are a Swede, you are a Muslim. So I want to ask you this, sir, world traveled, you know, historian, you name it. What is the master plan by the George Soroses? What in the hell are they thinking?
I don't care what his master plan is. This emigre needs to be rounded up by Interpol, in my opinion. When Donald Trump becomes president, all I can say is George Soros better not be in America. Because one of the first things that Trump has to do, I don't know how many different things he has to do at once. The first thing is the subversives.
I agree. And a good way to start, you just said it. Michael Savage and Alex Jones are calling for the war criminal wanted in many nations, who's overthrown nations financially, bingo, allied with radical Islam. We are bingo calling for George Soros to be deported the day Donald Trump is sworn in.
You can't deport him the first day. You can try him the first day. You can bring him in on charges of sedition, for example. Who gave this filthy billionaire emigre, this money changer in the Temple of Beauty, who gave this bum and his illegitimate, crazy family son? Did you see the son?
Totally.
Here's the beautiful part. I had it up on my website. I couldn't believe it over Labor Day. It showed the son of Soros, the biggest party animal now in the Hamptons, in a $72 million house, hanging around with disgusting rap stars, filthy, degenerate models, the whole pack of America.
Oh, if you Google his image, his son, he's totally whacked out of his brain.
This cockeyed bum is now hanging out with the lowest of the scum in the rap world, the lowest of the scum from the runways, the gutter rats of the world are now hanging out with Soros' son, party animals. And this man is now going to take his father's ill-gained fortune. And I say ill-gained because to me, money trading is ill-gained. You want to go into this? I don't know how people can bet against currencies and make a living. I don't know how that's allowed. Can you explain that to me? The man almost collapsed the British pound.
He admits he tries to collapse countries. He's been trying to collapse the dollar for 50 years.
All right. We know who the arch enemy of freedom is. He has a name. In our opinion, he should be tried. In Scorched Earth, I have a whole chapter not only on the head of the snake, but all the subversive groups that I could find in America. It's 2 pages long, Alex. Some of them have benign names you've never heard of. Some you know, ACLU. All of these groups need to be investigated by the new UAC, House Un-American Activities Committee. Now, I know that's a red flag to all of the good liberals out there.
It should be.
Well, it shouldn't be a red flag.
No, listen, I want to say this. I want to say something real quick and then let you take over. I've always been for free speech to the most radical level. The problem is they're all organizing and saying they want to shut down talk radio. They want to shut down Matt Drudge. They want to shut down Breitbart. Hillary says the alt-right, that means Michael Savage is the dean, does not have a right to exist. When you start hearing Final Solution, literal Nazi rhetoric that I don't have a right to exist, I've got a black heart, You're evil. Matt Drudge is evil. I'm done. Listen, you come here, you overthrow the country, you bring in radical Muslims. You want to arrest me? The gloves are off. We're going to try you in front of a jury. Then we're going to lock your asses up. You want it? We're going to find out who the traitors are. Go ahead.
Alex, you know, the left was famous at agitprop. I believe after this election, whoever wins, we need to have a people's tribunal and have mock trials of Hillary Clinton, John Kerry, George Soros, all of the names that we know are involved with destroying our sovereignty and going after our First Amendment. There's nothing prohibiting such agitprop.
You can be the prosecutor.
Who?
You.
No, I'm not good as a lawyer. I can't even imitate lawyers. But the thing is, Alex, listen, we got to slow down. There's a lot of work to be done, because if Trump wins, and it looks like he could easily win unless they do one of two things, and I'm terrified of either of the options. One is the most horrible possibility. If it looks like he's going to beat her, you know they're not letting him get to the finish line. Let's let that hang in the air. Number two, let us say he wins. Well, what happens then? He is surrounded by neocons. They have already triangulated Trump. You saw that last week. He already brought in I think was on your show last week, the former head of the CIA under, was it?
Came out and criticized Trump.
The former head of the CIA under Clinton. He's using him as an advisor.
You're right. It was sure. That's Woolsey.
Yes. Yes, Woolsey. Why would he choose him? I'm already concerned about the whole. Trump will be on my radio show today, by the way, Good. Alex. He's scheduled to be on. And we're going to talk about terror. He's called for profiling today, incidentally, which, of course, is commonsensical, isn't it? Every cop in the world. I love the newspaper articles in the San Francisco area. They never show a perp unless he's got blonde hair and blue eyes. Can't find the perpetrator. You have to search.
By the way, in Sweden and Germany, they admit that even when it's a Muslim, they replace it with a blurred out image of a blonde haired German. And I interrupted you earlier when you were talking about how we go after subversives. When you're a multinational war criminal, former Nazi collaborator that's collapsed dozens of countries like George Soros, what do you do when a foreign power, a foreign group comes in and is trying to overthrow your country? What do we do to these subversives, just briefly? And then let's get back into, I agree, they're going to try to block Trump getting in. He's surging. His wave has turned into a tsunami. He's winning most of the battleground states. What are they going to do?
Why do you think blacks are coming over to him? Because they know she's a liar. I predicted 6 months ago the Hispanic males in particular will move to Trump.
Already happening.
For two reasons. I use common sense. I know these guys very well. They're a macho culture, number one. They don't like an old woman telling them what to do, let alone a woman. Number two, what does an Hispanic worker want? He wants what everyone else wants. I see them around construction sites every day. I bicycle by and talk to the pit crews, the foremen. These guys are building from 6 o'clock in the morning. They're the carpenters. They're the plumbers. They're the drywall. You know what I'm saying? And what do they have? The minute they get some money, they buy a pickup truck. They get some more money. They try to buy a little house in a far out suburb. I go to KFC on a weekend sometimes. Who do I see there? Hispanic men with their wives and their little daughters dressed up in a little dress. They just came from church. There's something beautiful there, Alex.
And they're driving American cars.
Yeah, but they don't want to be what they left behind in their hellhole, their third world polluted hellhole. They want the American dream. So who is their role model? They want to be like Donald Trump. They know they can't achieve that, but maybe they could be a little bit like him. Maybe some of his money and concept of making money will rub off on
them. Their grandkids could be like Trump. I mean, it took that long for Trump, too.
That's right. That's right. In other words, same in all of our families. My grandfather was an immigrant. Actually, my father was an immigrant. Sorry, not even my grandfather. I'm first generation American. I keep saying I have one foot in the old world, one foot in the new. So I do recognize how hard it is to be an American if you just get here. But we were taught, learn English, work hard, you'll succeed. And if you don't, just the way it is, then maybe
and Mr.
Will.
Savage, have you succeeded in everything? I mean, you've been successful in publishing, media, real estate, you name it.
It took me 30 years of struggle and being rejected. 1978, I earned my PhD from the University of California at Berkeley with straight A's. Not one university would hire me because I was the dreaded white male. They hired inferior. In every case, they hired women, minorities, and immigrants. And the ACLU proudly said, some Americans will have to put their lives on hold so others may move ahead. You don't know what it's like to shame yourself like I did. I had a sense of failure that no one will ever know. I don't want anyone to know. I was on the verge of suicide. but I wouldn't do it because of my children. I couldn't do that. I felt I had failed my ancestors, that after all this hard work, I couldn't even get a goddamn job teaching in a university because of the racism induced by the illegitimate, filthy scum called progressives.
But they forced you out into the real world where you dominated.
Academia can be the real world in some real science.
No, I mean, absolutely. But I'm saying they force you to build your own world, and look how much bigger it was than in their world.
I'm the worst nightmare they ever had. I have more of an audience in 1 minute of my show than I would have in 1 year in a university.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly.
Okay, so the point is, I get it. This was God's hand. I get that as well. I pray to God. I don't want to go into God, but Alex, when I was at the lowest point of my life,
I
prayed to God to save me so I could do his work. It didn't happen 2 minutes later. A boom didn't go off in heaven, but I had to wait.
But the dominoes started falling.
Well, here we are, Alex. But listen, this is just the beginning. Our work's only beginning in January, not now.
I agree. I mean, Trump clearly is going to win by a landslide. They're going to try to steal it. What do we do if they steal it? What do we do once he gets in?
Stop the coming civil war. Take the first word out of it. When I published Stop the Coming Civil War 2 books ago, some really good friends of ours said, take the word stop out of the title. They put start the civil war.
Yeah.
Start the coming civil war. There's only so much a people can take until they've had enough. And then their freedom has to kick in, because otherwise we're going to be slaves, all of us. There's nothing more to be said, Alex. I'm not calling for war. You know it's illegal. But there's a war going on. You know it. It's called Infowars.com. The information war. But why is the FBI in denial about radical Islam? I asked myself. Well, what if the Muslim Brotherhood had infiltrated them under the Obama administration? And moreover, Alex, I had the nightmare vision that Obama himself was an operative of the Muslim Brotherhood. And I've read this from you know, underground sources now for years. Former intelligence agents said that the Muslim Brotherhood had infiltrated the United States of America and planted a president in there. I know it's crazy, can't be.
No, I heard you 10 years ago. It's all proof. It's happened. It happened. We know out of Kenya they funded the overthrow of our ally in Egypt that was helping everybody live a stable life. I mean, this is evil. Our government allies with Wahhabists in Saudi Arabia.
Scorched Earth, Restoring America After Obama. I hate to keep talking about a book, but I have to talk about...
No, people need to get the book, and it's doing very well.
No, it's my manifesto. It's number one on iTunes as an audio book. It's very interesting. Number one on as an audio book. There is something going on out there, Alex. Then I wake up, bombings in New York, stabbings in Minneapolis. Is this not Obama's legacy? The scorched earth policies practiced towards the police and the intelligence services, making them look the other way when they know who the terrorists are, not able to say it. Alex, it's going to get worse, but these horrible events that just occurred were the hand of God. Hillary slipping, hand of God. Terrorist events, hands of God. Every time these things happen, the people open their eyes just a little bit more. They wipe a little bit more of the wax out of their eyes, Alex. Trump, if he wins, that's where our trouble begins. That's where our work begins.
Well, listen,
begins.
I know you're a busy man, but promise me in the next few weeks, months, before the election's over in 49 days, you'll come back on to talk about all this, Dr. Savage.
Only if you tell me you're going to preserve your voice for the rest of the day.
I will. Thank you so much. Donald Trump coming on your show in a few hours. Michael Savage, our guest. Thank you so much. The new book, Scorched Earth. Stay with us. Thank you, Dr. Savage.
You're the best, the Alex. Keep it up.
Thank you. All right, if you just tuned in, Dr. Michael Savage was on with us for 30 minutes. I got really upset during the first hour, and I have a problem when I get upset. I scream in a way that really blows my vocals. I can scream loud, yell loud without hurting my vocals if I want. When I genuinely get mad, you'll tell my voice is gone for a day or two, and I have just butchered my voice now because it's just so fantastical, so cloud cuckoo land to have Hillary go, I saw the bombings in New Jersey and D.C. today, and it's wrong that Donald Trump's calling it a bombing. And the media hopping around going, oh, yes, it's the fall of Donald Trump. He's so evil. And then Hillary saying, it's Donald Trump's fault. Terrorists hit us. This is not a bombing. It's not a terror attack. And it's the fault of Donald Trump. The terrorists attacked us. It's like 5-year-old debating teams are better. And I'm not joking. I've seen little kids in debate clubs. Maybe in, you know, second, third grade, they've got them by then. And they're better than Hillary. It's like this propped up, sleepy-eyed, brain damaged epileptic. And I'm not, and then they go, Alex Jones making fun of epileptics. No, I'm saying she's running for president. She's falling apart. She's obviously had brain surgeries. They admit she has. She's disintegrating. And they're telling us it's no big deal. Just accept it. I'm not. I will now open the phones up to talk about the terror attacks, the bombings that have hit New Jersey, the stabbing attacks, the ongoing daily events we see in Europe and in other areas with the Islamist attack. Ahmed Khan Rahimi, shot by police, Rahim, shot by police there in New York in a shootout. We've got all this going on. But I also want to be clear to people. I am the person. I mean, I'm not bragging. I just want you to get the newsflash here if you're a new listener. I am the person that popularized the term false flag. I'm the person that popularized the term manufactured terror. I'm the person that popularized in terror circumstances inside job. So when I see comments on InfoWars or YouTube, other places saying, oh, look at Jones, it's all false flag, it's all actors, it's all fake. What the hell? This guy would say stuff was fake for years, and now he's saying it's real. He's discredited. What I do is read and look over, especially at night, but also in the morning, hundreds of news articles. I read declassified communiques from Bobby Kennedy wanting to stage terror attacks against the U.S. Embassy in Honduras. I mean, there's thousands of examples. I get a feel for how these people operate. I study the globalists. I read the books they've written, whether it's by Cecil Rhodes or whether it's by John P. Holdren or whether it's by George Soros or David Rockefeller or Carol Quigley. And I pay attention. That's my job. And so what they did in the media for the last 12 years or so after 9/11, I know it's 16 now or 15 now, was they would misrepresent. They'd say, Alex Jones says radical Islam doesn't exist. Alex Jones says George Bush personally planted bombs in the tower along with firefighters in New York. Alex, and they're so deceptive that they might take that clip and play it and say, I said it. You know, out of context, that's what they do. I didn't ever say that. I said radical Islam is being funded and protected by our government. The FBI said they were ordered to stand down and let the attacks take place. That way they can take our liberties here domestically. And then the deal with Saudi Arabia is to give them control globally to take over all these other countries. And that's what I said. That's what I covered. That's what I did. And then now I see Islamic State that isn't a couple thousand Al-Qaeda people in shadowy areas occasionally trying to activate kind of sleeper cell useful idiots go out and carry out low-level asymmetrical attacks for them. Or the FBI finding some mental patient to try to get funding and having them try to blow up, you know, let's say the Oregon, you know, Christmas tree in Portland or in Seattle, like we see. We've covered all that. We know that goes on. When there's evidence of it, we talk about it. And this could have been a staged event, but when you turn loose a 500,000 jihad fighters out of the Middle East and send 200,000 alone to Libya and over 200,000 to Syria, and Western governments give them intelligence and weapons and protect them, and patriots in the government give us all the intel, we break it first because folks know. Good sources give us info, we check it out. Might get me killed a week from now or put in prison. I'm going to publish it. So we exposed it all before it happened, before Syria even took place, before Libya took place, the plan for a failed state. We broke it all down because it's our duty. It's our job. And I watched over 500,000 worldwide jihadis. They're in 20-plus countries right now, 22, 23, 24, depending on how you look at it, murdering, killing, being protected. And I see at college campuses in person, on the street, and at airports, and then online, ISIS flags at political rallies all over, and ISIS billboards, and Islam, radical Islam, being super sexy and cool, and like the new leftist ambrosia in the last 5, 6, 7 years. And then I see Obama working with his cousin and destabilizing Kenya and the attacks on the malls, and are you a Muslim? If you're not, they kill you. And these Christians don't betray Christ. They get killed. They have amazing people. I go, my gosh, all the real radical right-wingers that were saying all this, they were actually right. I wasn't seeing Islam as a big threat globally. I knew it had major problems and was out of control in third world and evil and anti-woman and dark ages and all this. But I wasn't actually thinking the globalists would actually bring it in to conquer us. I thought they were letting some of it in to attack us to take our rights. Oh, it's beyond that. They let them attack us to put the whole NSA control grid in place, which they admit is mainly used against patriots and sovereign nations, to bring down all the sovereign nations under global government and use Muslims as the foot soldiers under collapsing borders and collapsing Middle East to be brought into Central Asia, South Asia, East Asia, Southern Europe, Eastern Europe, Western Europe, to then be the political operatives of the leftists as the actual foot soldiers to go in and destabilize things, to bring in civil emergencies, martial law, and then start arresting the political opponents of Islam, claiming Islam is attacking because you insulted it. And now, I was sure of this about 3-4 years ago. I went from not believing it to having one of the most detailed analysis once I understood it. Once I implemented the understanding with the data I already had, then it brought us a very clear battlefront, full-spectrum analysis of exactly what we were facing. And it's abominable. It is absolutely blasphemous, and you can see it. It's the fall of Russia, the fall of Europe, the fall of Canada, the fall of the U.S., the fall of Australia, the fall of the Mediterranean nations, the fall of basically Southeast Asia to Islam. At least using Islam as the frontline shock troops to start civil wars, then the globalists come in behind and clean up. But if you look at the actual battle layout of this, I don't think they'll be able to clean it up. I think it is an Islamic takeover, a satanic Islamic takeover. But if you study the way Islam has been deployed in modern times, it is a satanic religion. I mean, I'll just be honest with you. I'll just say it here and be a major target. I don't care. I'm already a target of the New World Order. It is a satanic movement. It is devil worship, basically. And it is an attack on knowledge, an attack on freedom, an attack on free will, an attack on women, an attack on art, an attack on literature, an attack on culture, being directed by the sycophantic left who hated art and literature and culture and Renaissance. That's why they set themselves up with major banker funding as those that gave out money to all the arts and film to be the controllers of it, so they could say that they were the ones, the guardians of art, the controllers of art, those that progenerated the art so they could control it. But now they know they can't control it. Hollywood's falling, so now they want to kill it. And they're flipping back to Islam, merging with the new leftist political correctness of social justice warrior systems like Sweden and Germany, saying your culture's dead. It's bad if you're a German. It's bad if you're Swede. You will wear the hijab. You will take a Muslim man. Your time is over. If they crap in the pool when you're there with your kids, you worship it. You submit to it. You are cuckold. You are broken. You are fallen. Submit. And so that's the battle plan. That's the program. That's the piece of art the globalists are producing. That's who they are. And there's no doubt about it. You know, Savage, I wanted to interrupt him because, you know, he was on target with official numbers about 600,000 Muslims under Obama and the rest of it. Remember, we first broke 2.5 years ago that they were bringing people in from Latin America with no IDs. Most of them weren't children. They were just being brought in with diseases, you name it. And the Border Patrol was ordered just to stand down and keep it secret. It's the same thing with the Muslims. It's just kept secret. We don't know. But the numbers must be extremely high from what I'm seeing around the country. Just like Europe, the first few years, they claimed it was 100,000. It was millions. So this is really serious what's happening. And you have to understand, the average Muslim is a victim of the cult they're in, the Wahhabist cult they're in. The average Muslim is a sad person. I would rather be free. I didn't want to bomb them. I was against those wars. I wasn't for the clash of civilizations. I tried to stop this. Here's the deal. We didn't stop it, and it was worse than I thought. I mean, look, I've got blind spots. We have a lot of sources. We have a lot of data. We have a lot of the emails and hacks. But when I talked about Hillary's crimes and first broke it 4 years ago with Tosh Plumlee and others here, CIA whistleblowers, about her and the foundation and her and the State Department and the weapons and the systems that were being transferred, I never thought when she was representing world leaders, I thought it was just against the U.S. And she was just selling out our interest. It was worse than I thought. She was even representing the Chinese president and more than 30 other leaders selling out their interest to corporations. But that's what Spectre is. I mean, that's what the James Bond villain organization is, which Ian Fleming admitted was based on real organizations MI6 had faced. And then MI6 had faced infiltration by groups that they didn't know who the hell ran them. They would just take cyanide. If you caught them, they'd be dead. I mean, this is what we're dealing with, folks, is an evil ancient organization so powerful, we don't even know who it is, okay? But then I look at the infiltration of the Masons by Muslims. I look at a lot of their regalia, and I'm not saying the Masons are involved. I'm saying it's so big that it's just in everything, and I think it's Islam. And something behind Islam. But I'm telling you, Islam is Satan's sword. Islam is Satan's sword. Islam is the New World Order skeleton key. It's the thing they use to open every door. It's always popping up. And you're like, well, yeah, and that's to go kill Muslims and blame it on them. Exactly. But you kill 1.5 billion Muslims. I mean, you know, you kill millions of them. More just pop up. And it makes it stronger, you understand? We're kept in a weakened state to never fight. They're put in a state to make them stronger. You actually study this. This is a takeover, folks. And it is anti-woman. And that's why you know it's satanic. Everything this thing does, when you get down to the base of Satanism, is about attacking women and the life force energy that God gave us. And a lot of this isn't in books either, folks. I've done deep study. It's so complex, I can barely even grasp it in my mind. But I am seeing the master design of the enemy because I'm throwing away all the preconceived notions I had and just really looking at the raw data, and it is horrible. Look at how everything Monsanto creates doesn't create its own seeds again. See, it's killing the life force, the progenitor, the engine, the earth at every level with the chemicals, the radiation, the Terminator seeds, the way they're going with humans where we won't be able to have children unless it's artificial, is about ending procreation. And you target the female to do that. This is a satanic force targeting creation. And I'm just here. I openly declare war against it. I mean, I've already declared war against it, obviously, but I just want to spiritually and openly here declare war and hope for God's providence and strength in this because I'm very weak against the enemy. I need God to give me self-control. And all of us need to ask God for the guidance and the directives against this because most people can't handle being a true Christian or loving God because if you do, you're going to get discernment. And then it's like jacking into Niagara Falls and you've got a straw trying to drink it. But I'm just telling you, ladies and gentlemen, we're already seeing pure evil on this planet. And it's only going to get worse until we the people stand up and say no. And you notice now this studio gets hotter as the day goes on. I'm not even sweating right now. The last few weeks, I've been in here just sweating every day, even though it wasn't that hot, because I just felt like I wanted to scream and yell and just say all this, but I didn't do it. And now that I've done it, I'm not sweating. I've been sweating bullets wanting to say all this. And you know what? I'm just going to say everything I think. I don't care. I don't care where the chips go. I don't care what people say. I don't care about MSNBC. I don't care about the New York Times. I don't care about any of you. You people are lost, and you know it. You have sold out to pure evil. I feel sorry for you. What is your problem? Good God, you are allied with Saudi Arabia that has women in literal bondage and men are in bondage as well. The most evil country probably in the world other than North Korea. Why? Whoa, 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 why? And it's because you're followers. You are open servants of evil. I've got to stop right there. I haven't even plugged anything monetary today. I plugged once last hour we have a new free app that's got free video streams and exclusive streams and news alerts, and it's about to be upgraded in a few months with some even cooler stuff. You go to Infowars.com/app or app, Infowars.com/app. We're going to have a pop-up if you're on a handheld device so that it pops up so you can download it for free, Droid or iPhone. Infowars.com/show, Infowars.com/app. This is the new app, okay? Our last one's 5 years old. It's got over a million people downloaded. It's great. It's just audio and a news feed. This one's audio, video, alerts, a bunch of new stuff's going to be added just on a routine basis in the next few months. Just new features will be added. Costs us a lot of money to make this app. A bunch of other stuff's going to be added to it. And the most important thing you can do is send this app on to your friends and family. Send them the link, Infowars.com/app, as a text to everyone you know with a cell phone or a, quote, smartphone. Send Infowars.com/app to them as a text link and say, hey, download this amazing free app to get all these amazing first look at videos and breaking news. Explain to them that this reaches 30 million people a week, that this is the cutting edge. Say, hey, this is the cutting edge. It just came out. Free app. InfoWars Live. Infowars.com/app. We're going to have breaking live videos. There's going to be so much, folks. Infowars.com/app. We're also running a special until Wednesday where you can get Super Male or Super Female Vitality, which is just known herbs, concentrated, cold-pressed. And it's just counters a lot of the globalist onslaught with the chemicals and the food and the water, in my experience. Just try it out for yourself. This isn't a game. It's not a joke. InfoWarsLive.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. I want to open the phones up at 800-259-9231. What do you think about the New York, New Jersey, and Minnesota attacks? You think I'm wrong? You see, they've got most people in a trance as classical tyranny is set up all around us. Those of us who aren't in trances are vigilant and are trying to stop what's happening. But once the dam breaks, once the next big world war starts or the economic collapse, or both, people are going to be ready to hear the truth like never before. And they're going to remember what you told them, what I told them, what others told them. And that's why there's a lot of hope, because the globalists are in serious trouble. I'm going to go to Tom in London and Nick in Minnesota and Eddie in Michigan and John in Wisconsin. Alex was an Uber driver in New York. A lot of folks, I don't like Uber because it's trying to have driverless cars in the future and create a monopoly. They announced by 2025 they're going to have a monopoly of cars. That's if the globalists let them. And Rahm Emanuel's brother is heavily involved. But I don't blame Uber drivers themselves for having a free market service that I think is great. I think where Uber's going is bad, but I didn't jump on the bandwagon of saying, look, Uber gouged people after the shooting in New York. It's an algorithm. A machine runs it. And when you go from, say, having 500 calls to 3,000 calls or 4,000 calls in a minute, people trying to get out of an area, the computer just charges you more because of peak time. It wasn't consciously doing it. But that's the problem with machines. You've given over your control. So that's just an example. We're going to your phone calls here in just a moment. But before I go any further, again, briefly, we have reporters in New York are coming up 30 minutes to the next hour on the scene. We have reporters all over the country. We're hiring more people. We're doing everything we can in the face of the New World Order to do the best job we can. That's why we need people to go to InfoWarsStore.com and get water filtration systems and get books and videos and to get high-quality non-GMO heirloom seeds that produce seeds and continue the life cycle. From 1,000 seeds, you can get 10,000 seeds. From 10,000 seeds, you can get a million seeds. I mean, depending on the type of seed you're talking about. We're here to basically counter everything the spirit of the New World Order is involved in. And whether it's seeds or water filters, they're the very best at the lowest price. InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. I didn't plug for an hour and 45 minutes, so now I'm plugging twice here at the end of the hour because we're doing okay because I plugged a lot in the last few months. The last month or so, I've not been plugging. We're starting to lose money. So I'm kind of getting to that position of support us, pray for us. You can obviously see the mission is important. Even though we're not perfect, we're doing the best we can. All right, who should I go to first? Where should we go? Should we go to Nick with the mass Islamic stabbing that wasn't an Islamic stabbing? Tom in London on Trump and terrorism? John in Wisconsin on the bombing? Let's talk to Alex since he's in New York. And by the way, you know what? I'm going to go to Alex in a minute. I don't want to cut Alex off. Now, the Associated Press is reporting, this just came in, that Ahmed Khan Rahimi, get it right that time? Rahami. Yeah. Ahmed Khan Rahami was found in the doorway of like a restaurant coffee shop. And they called him about the bum that was there when the police came He was discovered. He had a gun reportedly, and a shootout began. See, I couldn't be a cop because I knew that it was the reported bomber. I mean, I wouldn't even let him. He shot two cops before they shot him. I couldn't be a cop because I'd be trigger happy. An Afghan immigrant wanted for questioning, a little sweet immigrant. Almost all the terrorists are immigrants, but it's okay because, see, they're coming from countries where it's their job to kill us, so it's all right. It's their culture. An Afghan immigrant wanted for questioning in the bombings that rocked New York City neighborhood and New Jersey shore town was captured Monday after being wounded in a gun battle with police that erupted when he was discovered sleeping in a bar doorway. The 28-year-old appeared conscious, his upper right arm bandaged and blood, as he was loaded in an ambulance. Two officers were wounded in the shootout but were not believed to be seriously hurt. He was a naturalized U.S. citizen from Afghanistan. All right, we'll be back. Stay with us for your phone calls in 70 seconds. All right, coming up in 30 minutes, our reporters are going to be on the ground in New York City. They were there last night. They're breaking down the latest as we now admit this is a terror attack, as they now admit that indeed it is Islamic, it is ISIS. Coming up later, I'm going to play the clip. I've mentioned that where Hillary blamed Donald Trump, saying he's angered ISIS by talking bad about him. I guess the Christians in Syria, the hundreds of thousands that were murdered, I guess it was their fault too. The left is truly the anti-left. They are the opposite of what they claim they are. They are people that team up with bullies, claim they control the arts, claim they are the progenitors of everything beautiful when they are the authors of pretty much everything ugly. Let's go to Alex in New York. Says he's an Uber driver. Go ahead.
Hi, Alex. It's an honor to be on your show.
Honor to talk to you. Go ahead.
I just wanted to, first of all, let the audience know about the mood in New York City. I had a customer this morning. She was crying when I brought up the subject. The stress level is beyond belief. There's police presence everywhere, machine guns, bomb squad. There are boats with machine guns on the rivers. It feels like a third world war zone country or something. I've been employing this tactic using my Uber car to talk to people, and I've brought thousands of people to the show. I'm not exaggerating. I've been driving for many years. But I also wanted to suggest it's very easy to become a Lyft or Uber driver and to use the platform to actually have one-on-one debates with people. And
I agree, and use it before they go to driverless cars, because Uber admits they want to get rid of humans very soon and be the driverless car system to create a monopoly. They admit that. So we need to keep Uber and Lyft human.
Oh, definitely. And I've been with them for more than 3 years, both Uber and Lyft. And you guys talk about it, but you guys sometimes miss it. I would love to some other day, you know, fill you in on the tactics they're using to drive the drivers out of the driver's seat. I mean, it's horrible the way they treat the drivers. The system is horrible. But for the time being, until the election, it takes one day to become a driver. And in the downtown, the most liberal places, it's the perfect opportunity to have one-on-one discussions with this brainwashed liberal population. And most people are so zombie. And when I tell them a couple of things, they come around. Half of them come around. It's amazing.
Exactly. No one's ever even reached out to someone who, quote, thinks they're a liberal. Being liberal doesn't mean allying yourself with radical Islam. But getting back to Uber and Lyft, they were in the news yesterday. I didn't cover it. I should have, saying that within either 25 years or I think it said 2025, I'm going from memory, quote, all cars will be driverless, and quote, said it's our goal to kick you out of your car. What an arrogant statement.
Well, yeah, you have been covering this forever. This is all connected to globalists, the United Nations, how they don't want a society with drivers, and you know, and the way they're doing it, an average driver in taxi used to make about $70,000 to $100,000 a year. You know, you work a lot, but you make good money. But the way, what they're doing is they're lowering the income of the drivers so that when they bring in the machines, the drivers don't revolt. When they bring in the machines, there are going to be 10 million people or more who are going to be out of a job. This is a low-skill, high-paying job.
And again, this is social engineering. They admit with truck driving, they're doing that as well, so that it won't be desirable when it all goes automated. Then it'll be a few monopolies Then they'll drive up prices. Then everything will be a technocracy, just like the new Snowden film shows, where they put kill switches in the Japanese, the Swiss, the Germans, you name it, infrastructure, including American infrastructure, to turn it off anytime they want. Stay there. I want to come back to you, Alex. Let's do this now. Spend a few minutes on being in New York, experiencing it. Because, listen, phasing humans out starts in factories, in cars, and in trucks. This is not part of progress. It's been actuaried and engineered to bring humans out of the equation so we can then be made obsolete and phased out. That's the official plan of the Club of Rome, Davos, and Bilderberg. This is an emergency transmission. I'm going to go to Alex and John and Tom in London and Nick and Terry here in just a moment. Alex is a Uber driver calling in talking about how they're slowly engineering it where humans are ready to quit. And then Uber has come out. I showed the mainstream headline earlier. I was going from memory. I thought they said within 2025, that would be 9 years or 8 years, roughly, that they'd phase humans out of all cars. But no, they're saying astonishing self-driving Uber cars hit the road and will take over within 5 years. And the headline I saw was, humans will be kicked out of cars by 2025. And it doesn't matter if they crash or who they kill or what they do. They've got insurance on it. They're preparing it to up your insurance to where you can't be a driver. And then you can't control your thermostat. And you can't decide what job you're going to have or where your kid goes. Because the computers are all going to decide. Oh, it came from the grassroots. The Zeitgeist movement 10 years ago, promoted by the UN and the New York Times, where a friendly computer decides where you work and how many calories you get every day, but who programs the computer? And I was the tyrant, that guy in his made-up name, you know, Peter Joseph, when I said, well, if I don't want to be part of this, what happens to me? And he said, you'll be put in a re-education camp, close quote. Then he called me and he said, you will remove that lie, I never said it. And I'm like, we have the video. And he goes, it doesn't matter. I talk like this and wear black. I'm a pseudo-intellectual and wear black. We will all live in sports dormitories at sports stadiums of plastic, and the computer will tell us how to talk and what to do, and we will only receive meat one time a year. And then they came out with TV shows for kids in England that they show them in public schools that says, I love the future. I only get meat once a year, but the computer tells me what I do and what my husband does. Ha, ha, ha. The megapolis is so fun. I used to have decision-making, but now I don't. Thank God I don't. And you're like, this is satire. This is dystopic. No, 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 it's not. They've already got, they think, young people totally in a unconscious program state. And that's why they come out in Swedish TV and go, Sweden's time is over. It's no longer about being Swede. It's about accepting Islam and wearing the hijab. Submit to it now. There is no stopping it. And you're like, that looks like a dystopic joke. It's not. Because you're conscious still. You don't understand. To an unconscious trendy, their personality is whatever the popular trendy culture says. They're gone. And more people are falling to this. They're unconscious, and they're coming for us. They're ready to sit down, not be bipedal, but squat with a headset on, be in virtual reality as Zuckerberg strolls like a god past them. Ha, 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 smiling with a feline look of enjoyment at his quarry. Understand, you're not getting my opinion here. You're not getting my distorted view of things. You're getting an organic human warning. In fact, it's worse than I'm telling you. There's no way to even try to tell you all this stuff. There's too much. But I'm not getting in a self-driving car ever. And it's going to cost, watch, at first it'll be 90% as much. And people won't, like, oh, it's 80 now. Oh, this week driverless is free. Oh, yeah. I didn't used to dislike it, but now I like it. You know, I don't like these smartphones, but they're so useful. Oh, I know. I don't want to let my kids watch TV all day, but come on. I deserve a break, too. It's all designed to suck you in. The ultimate predator, designed in the war labs of the globalist, testing, always probing. Their own minions at the labs compartmentalized, not even knowing what they're really working on in full. Too busy, fearfully following the boss's orders. Creating their own obsolescence. But the higher-ups in the very top crust, only 6,000 of them, according to the Kissinger Group. I was offered entry into it. 6,000 that will be given life extension. 6,000 that will ascend to the Godhead. When I was offered that by Rothkopf, I mentioned that because he didn't do it in confidence. He did in front of John Harmon. But I've been offered it other times. They're like, Alex, the public is profane. They will fall. They will destroy you. I know what we're doing looks ugly on the surface, but it's an emergency surgery. The earth is infested. We have to do it now. Now, the fact that you can see it means you're one of us. You should really join. And they say, it's very sad you're not joining. It's been almost 10 years. Rothkopf was one of the last, about 9 years ago. I haven't been offered to sell out in a long time because they know I'm already sold out to somebody else. And they think you're a failure because you don't piss on your fellow humans and screw people over. I'm telling you, you people that sold out to the devil, you're going to fall, and you're going to fall hard. And even if you had in the future cures to incurable things that my children may have, adult children in the future, that can see those scenarios, I will never join you no matter what, because anything you give us comes with a price of our souls, and that's the only thing that really matters. All right, let's go to phone calls. This is how I really feel all the time. If I hold it back, you know, I just, the point is that Alex in New York, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Alex, I don't know if I'll get the chance to talk to you again.
No, take the time. Tom in London's next. He doesn't mind holding. Go ahead. Tell the story. What have you experienced? Why'd you call in?
Okay. So, look, I tried to organize drivers at one point, and I failed because it was my first time, but I learned a lot. And people don't want to take action. They always want to get something for free. And you guys, listeners, my brothers, my sisters.
They use false competition to screw us over.
Well, no, but beyond that, when you say to the listeners that we are the resistance, that is not a joke. And listeners, you guys, girls, you have to take action. And I cannot stress the importance of this election. When you drive, you will experience, you talk about God, when you go to a courthouse and all of a sudden you see the corruption, it's like godly. You will meet people. People will get into your car. That will blow your mind. Billionaires, journalists, politicians. I had the attorney general in my car of California. I mean, and get a dash cam. I have recorded almost a year of content now. I'm going to quit and try to put this on the internet pretty soon.
By the way, I agree. I agree. We now need to start hitting them. When the globalists do evil things and say evil things against humanity, we need to release it and leak it. All of us must become info warriors and target these people. And I'm sorry, good people don't have this instinct. We have to aggressively assault them in the information war. We have to attack them because they're attacking us. It's time to strike back.
Alex, last week I had a Hillary Clinton operative in my car who worked for the Clinton operation. In her words, she said, we're targeting the Latino population. And I have her on the camera, on the dash cam, and I'm questioning her. I'm trying to get more out of it. I wish the ride was longer. But the things that this woman, she said she doesn't like Hillary, but she's doing it. She's an opportunist, blah, blah, blah. You will get stuff, dirt on people you will never imagine. You guys,
that's the thing. They think they're smart because they have no morals and are opportunists. No, you're dumbasses because your decisions will destroy humanity.
They're evil, they are selfish, and they're wicked, and they're cowards. They're cowards beyond belief. And look, you, everyone listening, you are powerful beyond your imagination. And Alex is a proof of that.
I just can't believe, just like you just said, Alex, what you're saying is powerful. That's the essence. They think they're screwing everybody else. They don't get they're being screwed, too. They're delusional. They're missing something. If I even think about screwing someone over, and I'm not even consciously wanting it, but I'm wargaming it, I go, ugh, like it's attacking me. And I just don't understand people that are missing the instinct that God gave us to not want to screw people. But I want to tell everybody else something. Those of you that are missing the instinct to want to fight people that are screwing over folks, it's not enough to not screw people over. You have to go after bad people. And you have to identify them. You have to make sure you're right about it. You have to double check everything, and then you got to go after them. And I don't mean physically, but I'm telling you, folks, this is what has to happen. God bless you, Alex. Great points. I think you should start putting information out. And I think everybody should demand. We want humans. We want humans involved in what we're doing. I mean, I still go up to places that are automated with tickets and physically get my ticket, even though I was pre-purchased, because I want humans in the movie theater. And they'll act all pissed like I made them do some work. I'm there trying to maintain their job. And people can say, well, you're just killing innovation. I'm going to skip this network break. I'm going to skip it. They can say I'm sitting there killing innovation. I'm not. It's like McDonald's bragged 60 years ago that they put out trash cans saying, thank you. And so before you'd go in, there'd be somebody to clean the tables, keep them nice. You expected better quality at even a fast food place. There was an entry level, you know, minimum wage job for some 16-year-old or 15-year-old. And so you sat at a clean table and things were nice and you expected it to be clean. And there was a trash can over there and people threw the food away for you. They put that in and said, thank you. You know, help keep costs down is the new thing. Well, you're just getting crappier and crappier. You're not keeping costs down. You're driving the quality of everything. When we take care of our old people, when we take care of our cultures, when we take care of things, then we demand more quality, demand more jobs, demand diversity in the economy. Humans can build unlimited economies. The globalists admit this in so many white papers that how do we suppress them? Back in the 90s, the economies globally are growing too fast. They'll get out of the control of our structure soon if we don't suppress them. So they create depressions in select areas to make sure that only their controlled economy was growing, no one else. See, that's the thing, is that they took a free market and then they rigged it with computers. And now they want to rig it where you can't even have kids. You're going to be so poor. And folks go, well, there are too many people. Look at these cities. That's an illusion when you're in a big compact city because everybody's gone to that city for jobs. And especially in the West, some areas are really bad in China and India and need to be industrialized. But in the West, if you don't have 2.1 kids, everything collapses. Italy's having like 1.3 children. Japan's having 1.3 children. Germany's having like 1.5 children. They're collapsing. And then the globalists say, well, we'll just bring in Muslims to replace them. Okay, well, if there were Muslim countries that weren't as radical, I'd actually be fine with that. But they're bringing in people who are totally incompatible, even in their own countries. We're bringing in people whose religion is so out of control that they're always in civil wars with each other. Because their culture isn't about building new devices or having better farming or science. Because let's take where Muslim religion comes from, the Arabs. High IQs on average. Very high IQs. Mathematics, you name it. Astronomy, a bunch of it, pretty much invented there. The alphabet. Our alphabet is Aramaic. Isn't going on anymore. It's what you called Aramaic. Predates the Muslims. Christ wrote in Aramaic. So you take areas where most of the innovations came from with the very same genetics. What happened to it 1,400 years ago where now it came to a standstill? Because it no longer became about science and development and technology in the culture. It became about a cult, micromanaging your behavior and what you did. And look, Christianity has had witch hunts too. I'm not going to just sit here and bash Islam all day and not point out Christianity's had dark ages. Christianity's had inquisitions. Christianity has done stuff just like Islam's done. Do you know what? We reformed it and made it more Christ-like. Christianity in the last 200 years is a lot closer to what Christ said than to what it was previous to that. Islam is out of control. Look at it. It's a frickin' cult. It's crazy. Imagine if Christians said, yes, we don't let our daughters talk back to us or have their faces seen, and we don't let women drive cars. It would be a total revolt, and it should be. But if Muslims do it, it's supposedly cute and funny. Okay, I apologize on one of your calls. Tom in London's up next, and we'll go to John in Washington Nick in Wisconsin and Terry in Minnesota, then our reporters are popping in. Tom in London, thanks for holding. You're on the air worldwide.
Hello, Sir Alex.
Go ahead, sir.
That's quick take, Michael. yeah, so a year and a bit ago, 12, 14 months ago, I put a bet on William Hill that Trump would be the president and that Brexit would go the way it did. And that was on 17th of July, 2015. I have the...
I would say you've done well, Lord Vader.
Well, yeah, thank you, Lord Darkhart, should we say. Lord Darkhart, not a bad name.
Yeah, if Emperor Palpatine said who I was, we go, you are now known as Lord Darkhart. I actually like that. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's not bad. So I didn't just say that, you know, to toot my horn, although I haven't won yet, of course, because it was a combination bet. They'll make you a market about anything.
You know, I was thinking about placing a bet there because it's legal for me to do it from here. I was thinking to actually placing one on a whole bunch of stuff just for comedy potential, but go ahead.
Yeah, it's pretty good. No, but it was the reason behind it. See, I don't want to put a down on things, but the reason I predicted Brexit and Trump president is because the establishment are in a negative reinforcement phase, I believe. And it is their pick. So they wanted the Brexit and they want Trump. Now, I think
you're saying they're engaging in complex psychology moves to like do everything against Trump to make it look like they actually hate him, but in truth they want him.
Yeah, and well, how we'll see for sure. And we saw this with Brexit. Queen came out and said she wanted Brexit. And there are loads of establishment figures. But while the media was bashing the idea of Brexit, it was a very clear sort of strategy. And what we're going to have with Trump, if I'm correct, is the media will be still attacking Trump, but the subtext of the storylines will be bad news about the economy, bad news about immigration, bad news about terrorism. There'll be attacks.
This is a very sophisticated point you raised, Tom, and I'll be honest. This is the type of thing that keeps me up at night, wondering if I've been suckered, wondering if this is all a great deception, because if the economy declines right before Trump's about to get in, that shows that they're wanting to get him in, some claim. The way the media is doing outrageous stuff and just doing things that look absolutely ridiculous would be something that would make Trump get in, and I would agree with that. But they genuinely are panicking. We have their internal emails. Some of these, I don't want to get into details, but we know somebody else didn't hack this and give it to us, okay? Let me just stop right there. I mean, some of this humet was gathered by yours truly himself. And let me tell you, behind the scenes, they're crapping their britches. So I don't think they're that sophisticated. I think they'll try to spin and make lemonade with lemons if Trump gets in. I think Brexit, you know, was like 10, 15 points higher than what we actually saw. I think we're seeing the arrogance of tyrants, just like we saw the arrogance of Hitler or you know, the arrogance of other tyrants in history. I really think we're seeing a biting off more than you can chew of event here.
I think, the media aren't controlled on a micro level. They're controlled on a more sort of macro level. And most of them are sort of wind-up toys. So they'll do, you know, they'll do what they do, but they're sort of put in a...
Okay, let me ask you this. Why would the Russian hardliners and the Russian nationalists be supporting Trump when the globalists are covertly supporting Trump, if you're correct? Because I think the Russian globalist split is real.
Well, I think what's going on with part of the Russian landscape supporting Trump is that they are seeing what we tend to be seeing.
Oh, you think the Russians are buying it? Okay.
Well, no, at some level they are buying it. Yeah, I think in the same way as our media are buying it. I mean,
the Russian intelligence agencies have put out reports and they've said, look, we hope for Trump. We don't think he's actually out to get us like Hillary is, which is true. But we know the same power structure's in place, so we're not hoping for much better. So whatever happens, we're staying out of it. I think for all intents and purposes, the Russians have stayed out of it. But, you know, I think there's a little bit bigger stuff going on here. Let me ask you this. Do you think Trump... Do you think Trump is BSing people when he, say, covers InfoWars stories? I mean, do you think Trump's an agent?
I don't think Trump's amazing. I think he seems like a pretty nice guy. And
I mean, there's no way. Listen, I've known globalists. They are very cold, very arrogant. Trump's the opposite. Let me just tell you, behind the scenes, the opposite.
He seems like a pretty nice guy. You know, I haven't met him. You have.
They may be delusional and think they're going to hoodwink the Brits and the Americans and the Russians. But let me tell you, we got those three countries against the New World Order. It's going to be in deep crap. I mean, good luck. That is the power. I mean, the UK, the United States, the Anglo-American establishment, if we seize that and we're not at war with the Russians, the Chinese and everybody else better watch their ass. I mean, that really seems like actually the power combine we need to promote free market and a new renaissance is the United States, Russia, and the UK allied in a new free market global system that is open and free and transparent. That's the type of global government I'd sign on to. So if you're saying they manipulated us with a bad world government to sell a good world government, yeah, okay, I get it. Is that what you're saying?
I agree that those three countries are very important, and that is why they're being targeted for destruction.
That's right, and that's why they have a spirit that's never been defeated and will not be defeated. There's bigger things going on here, Tom. All right, the enemy is not invincible. We'll be back. Stay with us. All right, Nick in Minnesota. We're going to go to you in just a moment, then Terry and a few others like John and Stephen and Brian. But I'm going to first, in a moment, go to one of our reporters that is on the street right now in New York City. Got a lot of folks that want to talk about what they've witnessed, what they've seen. Do they agree with Hillary Clinton that this is not a bombing, not a terror attack? But then conversely, she then changed a day later and said it's Donald Trump's fault. In fact, let's play that clip right now of Hillary Clinton blaming Trump, saying he's giving aid and comfort to terrorists, the very group that have been testified in Congress, she and Obama literally created and gave the weapons to. Here it is.
We know that a lot of the rhetoric we've heard from Donald Trump has been seized on by terrorists, in particular ISIS, because they are looking to make this into a war against Islam. Rather than a war against jihadists, violent terrorists, people who number in the maybe tens of thousands, not the tens of millions, they want to use that to recruit more fighters to their cause by turning it into a religious conflict. That's why I've been very clear. We're going after the bad guys, and we're going to get them. But we're not going to go after an entire religion and give ISIS exactly what it's wanting in order for them to enhance their position. Secondly, we know that Donald Trump's comments have been used online for recruitment of terrorists. We've heard that from former CIA director.
When she first said that over a year ago, it turned out that she'd been used. She runs these groups. I mean, they actually take orders from her in Saudi Arabia. I mean, this woman is incredible. This is so rich. But we've gone from it isn't a terrorist attack, it isn't a bombing, to now it's Donald Trump's fault for the terrorist attack. So let's go back to this witch who, thank God, the hand of doom is now equalizing, showing her justice. Just keep praying for justice against Hillary. No harm, just that God, however God's plan works, that Hillary be brought to justice. And that all of us be brought to justice. Pray for justice against the wicked ones. And we're all wicked, aren't we, Hillary? We've all got dark hearts. I know I have a dark heart. You think yours is pretty, don't you, sweetheart? Let's go ahead and play the rest of Sweetheart.
Made it a very clear point when he said Donald Trump is being used as a recruiting sergeant for the terrorists. We also know from the former head of our counterterrorism center, Matt Olson, that the kinds of rhetoric and language that
that's
Mr.
enough.
Trump
it's like blaming Benghazi on the YouTube video that didn't exist. This woman is a liar. She's on record. We've had all the people on General Flynn's come out. They were ordered to aid al-Qaeda. General Flynn said no, sort of working with the Russians. Our own military was forced to go to the Russians to stop ISIS and al-Qaeda. I mean, this is a soft coup. It happened. Good job to our military, because our government's been hijacked by offshore globalists. Owen Schroyer, amazing reporter for InfoWars.com, there with the great Michael Zimmerman as well. In fact, later I want to get Michael Zimmerman to pop in if he can some when David Knight's coming up to take over. So much has happened. Break down the latest. They found the reported bomber. There's another sleeper cell. They've arrested five others allegedly connected. He's now shot two police officers. I'm going to be honest. Why the hell they let him even get those shots off when they knew who he was and had him cornered? I mean, this is a foreign military officer, folks. That's who these people are. They don't have the same rights as American citizens. I'm sorry. I'm just done. Owen, go ahead.
Well, we're standing here just outside of where the explosion went off. And as you just illustrated, it's amazing how, you know, they're going to blame Trump. It's like they want to blame Trump for everything. They don't want to actually look for the issues. They don't want to talk about the real issues. They just take the real issues and then spin it and blame Donald Trump. But I love that point you just made where we went from this is not a terrorist attack, this is not a bombing, to, oh, Donald Trump is responsible for this terrorist bombing in New York. It's amazing how they just spin it like that. And it's sad that there's so many weak-minded Americans that just fall for it hook, line, and sinker.
I got to be honest. It actually makes me go crazy to like see her say, yeah, the bombings in New Jersey and New York, and it's wrong he's calling them bombings. It's like these people are like either they're the biggest scum in the world or we're the dumbest people in the world.
Well, and Alex, we got the response. We were shooting the videos. We were asking people what they thought about Hillary criticizing Trump for saying it's a bomb. And people are looking at me like I'm crazy. They're like, what are you talking about? It's a bomb. Like, what? Is grass green? Is the sky blue? Is rain wet? Yeah, it was a bomb. But we did find actually some Hillary supporters that somehow, you know, they managed to sneak around the fact it was a bomb. They're saying, oh, well, Trump said it too soon. You know, he shouldn't have said it. How dare he? That's not tolerant. We need to wait and see. No, a bomb is a bomb. Okay, you call it as you see it. Why do people hate the fact that Donald Trump calls it as they see it? This is what they would want, Alex.
We want in leaders that are decisive.
And so here's what they're going to do then, right? They're going to let all of these people come here from these radical Islamic countries that are war-torn, which we're responsible for. We've been reporting on this, but they're going to bring them all in. We're going to be reporting on how this is going on, and then they're going to say, oh, well, you need to be tolerant. So what, we're just going to wait until terrorist attacks happen every day, and then we can talk about radical Islamic terror? That's what the liberals want. They want.
Well, it's crazy. Whether it's the nightclub shooting killing 50-plus or the niece killing 90-plus, they keep saying it's not terror as long as they can, and then it comes out it was, discrediting them, but they're so delusional, thinking they're the only media that counts. They don't get that they're destroying themselves. Just a year ago, AP said mainstream media had a 15% trust rate. It's 6% now. I mean, don't they get it? Let's talk to some of these crew out there. Let's talk to some of the people on the streets in New York. Tell us where you are.
We are right outside. We're at 6th and 23rd. If you can see right down here, actually, the fire department is right here. They're trying to knock out some of these busted windows before they start to replace them. You can see that there's a church right there that had all of its windows blown out during the explosion. I wonder if that had anything to do with it. But you want us to talk to some of these people here, Alex?
Absolutely.
All right, you want us to see what they think about Hillary?
Yes.
Do you mind talking, ma'am?
I don't care. Don't want me.
What do you think about Hillary Clinton criticizing Trump for calling it a bomb?
First of all, Hillary, I think for one thing, she's entitled to her opinion, number one. Number two, Donald Trump is no bargain. Donald Trump is a lot worse than what she said.
So are you going to vote for Hillary?
She's for women's rights. I would say yes.
So you think she's for women's rights? She says that you want to be able to.
As what she said with Donald Trump's reporters. Okay, she's in a bit on the wrong. I agree 1,000%. But as far as I'm concerned, but for also speaking her opinion, I think she should, be entitled to her opinion
Ask her about supporting Islam. What she thinks about that? Is that good for women?
And all that stuff together. But as far as her with the Donald Trump incident, I would say she's wrong on that behalf.
Well, let me ask you this real quick, because Hillary wants to bring in more people from these Muslim countries where they don't treat women with respect. What do you think about that for women's rights?
Well, for one thing, now that's going way too far. If she says what she says about supporting the Democrats, taking care of, people that are here, instead of bringing people, the Muslims, all the United States, and then this happens. How do you know the people that you bring in is going to go and do the next bombing? How do you know if the bombing is not going to be under the train station or buses? I take the subway.
Or 80% of men on welfare. That's my big problem. All right, tell her thanks. Next person. Nice lady.
Sorry, we got to cut. Thank you for your time, ma'am. You want to talk to someone else, Alex?
Yes, so keep going. Take over.
All right, sir, you mind answering some questions?
Yeah.
What do you think about Hillary Clinton criticizing Donald Trump for calling this a bombing?
Oh, I don't know about that, because something I don't know, you know, I can't say nothing about that. But if I know, you know, I see something, but I don't know.
I know nothing.
You think it was a bombing, though, right?
I don't think so.
I don't think so. It's well, the government has admitted it was a terrorist bombing. God.
I don't think so.
Go talk to that pseudo-intellectual guy behind him.
I don't know. I don't know exactly, you know, what happened.
See the white-haired pseudo-intellectual?
Right. Yeah, I see him. Excuse me, sir. Do you mind answering a quick question? What do you think about Hillary Clinton criticizing Donald Trump for calling this a bombing?
Well, it was a bombing. And so
you think, what, is she just a liar or crazy?
I think she spoke before she had the proper information, didn't she? Like,
see, I'm calling him a trendy. This is New York. He's a smart guy. I apologize.
That's actually true. Good point, sir. Thank you for your time.
Let's talk to the genius.
Hold on. This woman does not like Hillary. What do you think about Hillary Clinton?
I don't like her. And I think it was wrong. Donald Trump trumped her on calling it a bomb, exactly what it is.
So, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Who'd you want me to talk to, Alex?
I don't know. I shouldn't be mean. The guy kind of looked liberal, and he was actually in the real world. But I was just,
yeah, he actually,
I mean, look, we
talked
to Democrats. I'm not being mean. They can't talk. They don't know what planet they're on. But I guess let's talk to some more of them. We'll talk to Republicans. They're, like, smart. I mean, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Look at this, Alex. This is a dynamic that we have illustrated, and anybody can witness. If you talk to Donald Trump supporters, they want political discourse. They want to engage in debate. If you talk to Hillary Clinton supporters, as soon as you disagree, they run away.
Well, it's worse than that. I mean, they don't even know what planet they're on. They go, no, this was not a bombing. It's now admitted to be a bombing. The guy says, no, it's not a bombing. He knows to go along with the system. That's what he's actually doing. But here's what I'm getting at. This isn't, when we do this or Mark Dice does it, people think we're editing it. This is live right now on radio and TV. These are the Democrats we're talking to. I would ask him if they can find their ass with both hands. Go ahead.
What's that, sir? Hold on.
Hold away.
Yeah, are you a Hillary Clinton supporter?
Absolutely.
So what do you think about her criticizing Donald Trump for calling this a bombing?
Criticizing for someone for spreading information before all the facts are known.
Oh, we're letting them put it out.
Hold on a second.
Two bombs in a day, dumbass.
Hey, if I walk over
there. See, this guy controls reality. Look at this pinhead.
Hold on, sir.
No, talk to Pinhead.
Hold on.
Pinhead controls reality.
Can I talk for a second?
This is one of the brain bugs. This is one of the smarter ones. This guy can probably tie shoelaces.
If I walk down the street and I see a blade of grass, and I call it a blade of grass before I take it into a lab and analyze it, but I was right, isn't that? I mean, that's pretty obvious, right? It's a blade of grass.
Right, but one thing is making comments about intelligence and public safety, and the other is a blade of grass.
Okay, so let's
but
say
was
that
he right?
Your opinion,
was he
let's
right,
say that
dumbass?
Your opinion is right here. Donald Trump was right, but Hillary Clinton also said it was a bomb, and then CNN cut it.
Piece of ugh.
Sure. What's your point?
So Hillary Clinton.
What's your point? I'm intellectual.
That's your conclusion from that Hillary Clinton
said it was a bomb, CNN cut it, and then Trump said it. But you're saying that's not hypocritical?
I'm saying that she's criticizing someone for spreading information without knowing all the facts.
She did it, too. She did the same thing, and CNN cut it. That's what I'm telling you.
I mean, look, you might be, I don't know. That's, if you're saying that she was wrong to criticize someone for doing something that she was doing herself, and that's hypocritical, then, you know, maybe you're right.
That is what happened.
But you're also calling her a liar or crazy.
Well, she's definitely a liar.
All right.
She said she doesn't have medical problems.
Okay. Do you think Hillary Clinton has any medical problems?
No. Well, pneumonia.
God. Just pneumonia? You
hey,
know
hey
pneumonia
ask him if he knows who Carl the Cuck is and what he'd like his name to be.
I didn't run away. I'm glad you spoke to me.
Ask if he knows who Carl the Cuck is.
Do you know who Carl the Cuck is?
What?
Do you know who Carl the Cuck is? Are you related?
No, I'm not.
All right, man. Hey, thank you for your time. Go back to work.
Enjoy your new meme.
Huh? Yeah. Hillary Clinton's not a liar.
Entertaining.
Hey, let's see. Hey, are there any Hillary
Clinton
supporters around
here? Look at that guy. Look at these people.
You like Hillary Clinton? What do you think about her criticizing Donald Trump for calling it a bombing?
I think she was correct. I support her.
So you don't think it was a bombing?
Excuse me?
Did a bombing happen here?
Yes.
So why would Hillary criticize Trump for calling it a bombing?
I have nothing to say, but you like Hillary.
These people don't know what planet they're on, man. We're screwed. Man, it's game over, man.
All right. Hey, thank you for your time. Thank you for your time.
Put her in charge.
Are there any Hillary Clinton supporters around here? I'm going to try to find any. Do you like Hillary, ma'am? Can I ask you a question? Why not? I'm a bully? I'm just going to give you a platform. Why do you like
He's
Hillary?
He's a bully.
You're not my boss. You're not my boss, buddy. I'm not going to listen to you. All right, you don't want to talk? All right, I'm a bully because I want to talk to people about politics.
But hey, look at Mr. Firehead over there. He's really smart.
Yeah, he was trying to boss me around. He thinks he's my boss.
Don't ask the cop it was a bombing. There's a cop right behind you. Right behind you.
Yeah, I don't want to bother them. They don't want to really talk to us much because they're kind of in work mode.
No, I understand.
I think there may have been a confrontation going on here.
Well, let's see. Let's go over there right now.
Okay.
This is live in New York City. Cops are surrounding this guy.
I'm not sure what happened here. All right, police are actually coming onto the scene now.
Ask him why the street is closed. They wouldn't even say that. Like, we wait for orders from Hillary to say anything. Hillary is gone. Hillary.
All right, I'm not sure what just happened here. Wait, what just happened? What was that about?
Fucking hit me, that fucking piece of shit.
All right, well, we got to delete that out. Go ahead and dump that.
There's a woman in a hijab. Let's go ask her.
Where is that?
Where 12 o'clock. She just walked past you. You're old 12 o'clock. Towards the cops. It doesn't matter. If you're a radio listener, total bedlam has ensued. We're at the site of the bombing. Tell us exactly where this is in New York.
23rd. We are at 23rd and 6th Street. Actually, the bombing, or the not bombing, whatever you want to call it, it happened right down there.
Yeah, exactly. You got to have permission from Hillary. No, she's called it a bombing now. It's okay. She says the terror attack was caused by Donald Trump, so it's now okay.
Right, this is the spin. First, it's not a bombing. It's not terror. And then what do they do when it comes out? It's both. Well, it's Trump's fault.
But notice, those people didn't even know what Hillary said. They're so suggestible. Yeah. You would say Hillary says it's not a bomb, but did, and said Trump was bad for saying it was a bomb.
What do you think about Hillary criticizing Trump for calling this a bombing?
A bombing? I think she needs a bomb in her brains. It's smarting up. How many people are going to be bullshitted by her?
Go ahead and dump that. The woman still has a brain.
One scandal after another. Read yesterday's post, Sunday's post. One scandal after another.
That's a fact. Looks like we got more Trump supporters here than we might expect.
Well, notice they're able to talk. Trump supporters are able to talk.
Trump is going to win, and this is going to be a catalyst to push him forward.
I agree with that. Trump was right that more terror would happen here. He just gets proven right again. I'm not sure if we can even find any Hillary Clinton supporters around that'll want to
talk. Talk to that guy behind you. He wanted to talk to you. The guy with the iPad behind you? Oh, right behind you.
I'm not really into the election thing. I'm saying I don't really vote, but I know for a fact Donald Trump is going to win. I'm against him personally, but, you know, it's life.
Hillary wins, you think it was completely rigged?
Yeah, definitely. But I wish Obama could be reelected again, but too bad the campaign is over and, you know, can't accept him again. But
what do you like about Obama?
I can't really talk much about it, but I know he did his job during his election and his time. You know what I'm saying? He's a good president. He's smart, really intelligent. But I feel like Donald Trump is, like, a little too aggressive. Like, you know, he's lying too. He's lying too, just like Hillary. But it's all like a scandal. You know what I'm saying? Everything is just about, it's rigged, basically. You know what I'm saying? I don't really want to talk too much about it.
Well, Trump says it's rigged. All right.
That's it, though.
All right.
Hey,
well, listen, Mr. Schroyer.
Infowars.com. Check us out. We're actually live right now. Yeah, go ahead, Alex.
What's it like being in the middle of New York City right now?
You know, the craziest thing, Alex, is when we're walking around and talking to these people, half the people we talk to, like, they don't even care. It's like they're not concerned. They don't care. They don't want to talk about it. They just want to go about living their lives. Well, you know, if this starts happening every day, are you going to care then? Are you going to have to be tolerant? I mean, what are you going to do? Eventually,
they think being self-serving gets them ahead. You understand? Their mothers and fathers didn't breastfeed them, didn't hold them next to them in bed. Studies show you don't hold a baby at least 3-4 hours a day up against your skin. They're not the soul doesn't come into their body, basically. They don't have souls. Those are dead people. Those are zombies. And I'm not joking. They're dead people. We're out there trying to find people that are actually alive. Stay with us. All right, they're there in New York, side of the bombing, the terrorist attack. We've won again. Oh, my gosh, what a victory. We proved it was a bombing in Islamic. But finishing up for TV viewers, imagine these, on average, super self-centered people. Imagine how they're going to behave, what's going to happen, what's going to unfold if there's a real terror attack or society collapsing or an economic attack or a nuclear attack, being around a bunch of people that'll sit there while a woman's raped in the street. This happens all the time. It won't help her. Like I said, the more liberal it gets, the higher the crime rate, the more the murders, and the more people don't give a damn about you, and the less charity. Going back to Owen Schroyer, we'll finish up and then go to a few calls. Any other points? I think you're going to be popping back in with David Knight in the fourth hour. Go ahead.
Well, yeah, like I said, you know, it's just strange to me when we talk to some of these people that they don't think, you know, they're either not concerned what happened here, they're not thinking about the explosion, they don't think anything else can come of this. Even though it just happened in their neighborhood, other explosive devices were found. If you look at the ratio or, you know, the number of events that are happening, it's increasing, it keeps going up, and yet the liberal politicians want to continue to try to bring all these people in, even though that we know they're not assimilating to our culture, and we're seeing what this is doing in our communities. There was a video that I saw, I think it was a man in Minnesota just walking down the streets, and he started getting harassed by a bunch of Muslims in his neighborhood, and they chased him away. I mean, what is that about? This is what we're seeing in Europe. So what we're seeing in Europe,
this is what Muslims do. Primitive people like the KKK see a black guy in their neighborhood 100 years ago. They go chase him and attack him. That's what the radical Muslims do. They kill a Shiite Muslim who's a minority if they see him in most Muslim countries. If you're a Shiite Muslim, they catch you in a Sunni area, you're dead. We're bringing cavemen into the country.
Well, and there used to be a system that you had to go through to assimilate, to prove why you wanted to be here, you know, to appreciate becoming a citizen, you know, to have that privilege. And they've just kind of brushed that whole system under the rug. They've just found a loophole around it. They go tear these countries up with their wars, and then they bring them in here, and they use the social justice warrior technique, the virtue signaling technique, to say, you have to take these people in. We have to do it.
What do you think of the new ads in Germany and in Sweden where it says, we're ending Germany and Sweden. The Muslims are taking over. They are the new Germans. They are the new Swedes.
It's just like when they were running ads in Mexico to come to America. It's just like when Obama is telling people in Central America, hey, come up to America. You know, we've got a free handout for you. We'll give you a bus pass wherever you're, you know, wherever your family's at.
Here's the deal. A Central American won't blow you up because you're a Christian.
Yeah, and that's
what I'm saying is it's a next level. All right, well, you're going to be popping in next hour with David Knight. Thank you so much.
All right, Alex, thank you.
Hey, I'm going to jam in calls in this segment the next that David Knight's taking over. He saw Snowden, agrees with me, says it's very powerful. Let's go ahead and talk to Nick in Minnesota. Nick, thanks for holding. You're a trooper. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. Hey, I was just kind of watching that those fly-by-night liberals just kind of, they get all their information from Facebook and from memes, and it's scary. But what I want to talk about is that I'm in St. Cloud, Minnesota. I'm a student down here. I'm studying radio. I listen to you every day. I go home, run straight home after class, bring out my notebook, and I listen and I study your guys' system. And what I found is that no one is reporting that this terrorist attack was stopped by a concealed carry ex-cop. I mean, this man is a hero. He saved people's lives in a Macy's in a mall in St. Cloud.
No, you're right. It was a retired police officer, former police chief, with a concealed carry. That's why they ignored it at first and said, oh, it was a cop. Yeah, he was a cop, but now he was a citizen. The point is, he was an armed patriot. And it was a retired police officer, retired police chief, took this guy out. Stay there. I'm going to come back to you, Nick. You're right. It's barely being reported. Then John, and then we'll go to Terry and many others. Stay with us. The ground force to stage the attacks, then the police state's put in place that's used against us. That's all admitted. That's the plan. And to make us then adopt Islam to, quote, not upset the radical Islamicists. By the way, the new app is free. It's about 6 months in the making. Free video feeds, audio feeds, special alerts, you name it. More features to be added. Infowars.com/app to get the free Droid or iPhone version. Or if you have a mobile device, it should pop up when you go to the site. It took us years to get 1 million people to download the one that has the free audio feed. David Knight's about to take over. I want to take a few more of your calls. But we have a lot of specials running right now at InfoWarsStore.com as well. Your funding is what makes all this possible. It's critical. Your funding is the second most important thing. Your prayers are number one. So thank you all for your support. Nick in Minnesota finishing up real quick. Yes, I noticed they first said somebody shot him. And they said, oh, it was a cop, which is fine. Give the cops the credit. That a lot of times they do it. Then it was, well, he was a retired police officer who had a concealed carry. So he was a retired police chief from a nearby town. So they don't want to say it's a citizen. It's an armed citizen. That's what happened. Go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, that's exactly it. And the first, you know, when I first heard about it, first thing went through my mind is that why don't I have a gun in my apartment? Why don't I have a concealed carry permit to protect people's lives?
Well, I read the police report on it that's now out, and it said that it was like a textbook. He found out it was happening within a minute. He'd already stabbed 9 people. He was stabbing another person, and the police officer said from like 15 feet away, drop it right now, and he didn't, so he shot him repeatedly and killed him. They said the video, they haven't released it yet, looks like a training scenario. Go ahead.
Yeah, exactly, and I've done military training like that before, and I mean, the way that they described it is exactly how you should do it, but I personally work with Muslims, and like none of them want to be here. They're all here because they're running from what's coming over here.
Well, I was about to say, I'll be honest, that's what I said. Most of the Muslims we all know and think are so cool from high school and college are heretics. They'll admit it to you. They don't dislike God. They're not. But the radical Islam that's taken over, they're all running. Obama started bringing in the actual radicals. That 80% military-age men that invaded Syria, they call them refugees. They are the people that the Syrians and the Russians defeated. They're bringing the jihadis here. Why do you think that?
Exactly. And I mean, it's so personal to me because my girlfriend works at that mall. She's a manager at that mall. And I mean, I'm thankful she had work off that day. But I mean, for somebody who has the ability and lacks the consciousness to be able to bring in somebody that's, you know, knowingly going to kill people is just sickening.
Well, I'll say this. Somalis don't deserve to be demonized as a people in total, but almost all of them are Muslim. They were all forced into being Muslims the last 100 years or so, and they have the highest per capita rate of committing terror attacks worldwide. So this is not the place we should be bringing folks in from. I'm sorry. And then they give black immigrants a really bad name because most of Africa is not Islamic and is being murdered by Muslims. I mean, Africa is facing the main brunt right now of the Islamic assault that our government's backing. So I apologize to Africa for that.
Yeah, I do too. I mean, I mean the ones I know and I work with are extremely nice people, but I grew up in Fargo, North Dakota. And, I mean, we were one of the highest areas for refugees in that during that time. And
yeah, but let me guess, that was back from the Iraq war and stuff. Those were people that weren't radical that wanted to come to America.
Exactly.
Obama is bringing a bunch of military-age men in that are Sunni jihadists, totally whacked out of their brains, raised in radical madrasas, and you might as well bring, you know, space aliens here. I mean, it's the worst thing you can do. I mean, look, they can't handle it. They see a woman in a miniskirt walking by, they flip out. They think, well, it's my right to rape her because she shouldn't be dressed like that. I'm going to hand the baton to David Knight straight ahead. More of your calls straight ahead. Our reporters are in New York. Stay with us. All right, I got callers that have been holding for over an hour. I want to run through a few of those quickly and then hand the baton to David Knight, who's chiming in the bit to cover a ton of news. But briefly going to David Knight to tell us what's coming up. David, wow, huge events taking place. What do you make of what you see unfolding right now? I mean, it's like Hillary lying, saying she has no health problems, collapsing. Her saying it's not a terrorist bombing. There's no ISIS. And then having to say, okay, Trump's behind ISIS. It seems like they're trying to discredit themselves.
Well, you know, Alex, what we see happening right now, I think is very dangerous. We're seeing two different things that you've been talking about today. One of them is the outright violence and the bombing campaign. The other one is the education campaign, the information war that you've been showing the videos out of Sweden and other places where they're indoctrinating people. And I call it Sharia in sheep's clothing because that's what they're selling these people. And there's a story this week where a Turkish man kicked this nurse, female nurse, in the head, in the face, because he didn't like the culottes that she was wearing. I mean, it wasn't anything immodest at all in what she was wearing. They were very low, long by Western standards. And yet, we've got this video at the same time in Sweden showing this woman with a ton of makeup, blonde, wearing the hijab, low-cut dress, high cut on the thigh. I looked at that. The first time I saw that, I said, if she wore that in public, she would be beaten with a stick by Hillary Clinton's donors. So we've got these two different things that are happening, Alex. It's like what we saw with Bill Ayers. Remember, he was going around bombing Pentagon buildings, not doing a whole lot of damage. And then he did a lot of damage by getting involved in education. And that's the real danger. That's, I think, even more dangerous, far more dangerous than these bombings that are happening or the knife attacks that are happening, the physical attacks that are happening. And that is this deception telling people that in the name of tolerance, they need to bring in people who have never exhibited any tolerance, especially to the women. When you were talking to Owen Schroyer at the in New York and he had that woman on the street, she said, oh, I'm for Hillary Clinton because Hillary's for women's rights. Well, what about the right to be able to walk down the street wearing whatever you wish? What about the right to be able to walk down the street and not be blown up with an improvised explosive device? How about those rights? That's what they don't
The truth is, these people don't have anything. They've been trained to be poor. They've been trained to have nothing. They've been trained it's cool to be trendy and have nothing. And so all they care about is allying with the political structure. That's their identity.
Yeah.
And it doesn't matter if it's not congruent with reality. They've given over their consciousness. They've given over their soul. And they're gone. And we should just worry about ourselves now. A lot of these people we can't reach. We have to triage it. And we have to reach out to those that still are reachable. David, thank you. You're coming up here in just a moment. Now you have your review of the film Snowden, which I intend to do this week as well. Truly a groundbreaking film. Let's go to John in Wisconsin. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, Alex, I'll tell you, I've got an uneasy feeling about this whole thing, especially the takedown of the guy that that they were after. How many jihadists that were armed have you seen live?
Well, it was a bombing attack. So if he's like hiding out in the doorway, I'm not sure what that means.
Well, usually the cops will just take him out and that's it, you know, and then you're left to wait for, you know, everybody hangs on every word that the official media puts.
No, I know government stages stuff, but what I keep explaining to everybody is the staging was bringing these people all in and then protecting him, and then ordering the government not to go after him officially a few years ago. And so all over the world, real jihad armies are invading and taking over. That's why this is different than what we saw during the Bush era.
These cops kind of acted the way they should act and the way they always used to act until they were retrained by the Southern Poverty Law Center. You know?
Exactly. I appreciate your call, John. Let's go ahead and talk to Terry in Minnesota. You're on the air.
Yeah, hi, Alex. How you doing? Listen, I got a student that goes to St. Cloud State, shops at the Crossroads Mall, and works in St. Cloud. And we were at his graduation. He's in a master program now. His graduation is June, and it was like I was floored because, I mean, St. Cloud State is it's way up in northern Minnesota, mid-state, whatever. It's like, and there was like 30% graduates were Muslims, fine and good. You go to the Walmart up there, it's like probably 80% that are employed by Walmart, Muslims, fine and good. And it's like when you see this and you see it happening in your own country and everything you've talked about, all the knowledge that you have amassed, what really prodded me to call in today is after you were, your release valve blew, per se. I felt sorry for you. And, you know, it's like, Alex, God is on the throne. God is in control. Everything is under control. And, you know, like, you take Trump and Clinton, the biggest difference between Trump and Clinton is Trump has compassion for humans, his fellow man.
That's right. He's not out to get America. He's not out to get the country. And I appreciate your call. Look, people get confused here. The globalists wrote a white paper called Rebuilding America's Defenses, and it was written in 2000. And it called to let radical Islam attack, protect it, kill as many people as killed at Pearl Harbor, which was 3,000. Incredible how it was actually 3,000 died on 9/11. Very, very spooky. And they said, we'll use that attack to go in and invade the Islamic world. And then out of the Islamic threat that will come out of this war, the planet will accept American domination. Now, this is written to sell the Pentagon on doing this, so it's all about America and the rest of it. It's still very Machiavellian, very, very worldly. But if you understand, the globalists are saying, we'll go in, stir up the Muslims, start a world war, you know, a worldwide conflict, a world war. Then out of that crisis, we'll have attacks in the West. And out of the attacks in the West, the globalists will then be able to actually take over our countries and set up a police state here. And so that's why they're doing it. The whole thing is a false flag, but it's real jihadis. It's real giant population blooms coming out of these Sunni Wahhabist areas with Merkel and the Germans and others advertising online to bring the Muslims to Europe to, quote, get women and your 40 acres and a mule. They're advertising in the EU with Peter Sutherland and in the UN, come here, colonize us, we want you to. And so when they show up and a small percentage of them commit jihad, we're told it isn't jihad because they want to get us ready for the full takeover that isn't physical bombs, but is cultural, where we've got to accept the hijab and our women having their genitals cut off, which is what they're actually pushing. Because if the globalists can get us, in the name of hospitality, to accept Islam, we'll accept socialism and globalism, the technocracy, any day. And so that's what's happening. We got loaded phones with Steve in Canada and many others. I don't know if David's going to get to your calls. I tried to get to them all. I appreciate your calls. I'll leave that up to David. He's got a lot to cover today. But I'm going to punch out here and take care of my other duties here around the office after 3 hours and 15 minutes. I'm going to briefly just add, we have the new InfoWars Live app. That is InfoWars.com/app, InfoWars.com/app. And it's got video, it's got audio, it's got text feeds, it's got alerts. And a lot more is going to get added as new functions. You don't have to re-download it. It'll just be there on the app at InfoWars.com/app. Or when you go on your device, if it's a handheld device, it'll pop up already for you to download via Droid or iPhone. It's free. So it doesn't, quote, support us overall. It supports the truth and gets the word out. Please send an email to your friends and family and tell them, or post on Facebook or Twitter, that the new free app is available. That's where the real power of this broadcast lies, is with you. And we also have a special that's about to end because they're about to sell out. 50% off Made in America. Keep America Free hats. Make America Free Again. Not Make America Great Again, which I agree with, but Make America Free Again. These are knockoffs of the Trump hats, but there are our own versions made here in America. Make America Free Again. Make America Free Again in red, blue, and camouflage. InfoWarsStore.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. I'm going to hand the baton to David Knight. The Nightly News is coming up tonight, 7 o'clock Central Standard Time. David Knight.
Thank you, Alex. And I'm going to take some of your phone calls here in just a moment. Before we do, I'm going to give you an idea of what we're going to talk about after the phone calls. One of the things I want to do is talk about the Snowden movie that I saw this weekend.
And by the way, feel free to skip the break since I took some of your time.
Oh, that's fine. We'll still get a break, but I'm going to take some of these phone calls. But later in the show, I'm going to talk about not only the Snowden movie, but the amazing fact that the Washington Post came after him the day after the movie was released on Friday, came back and said no pardon for Edward Snowden. And let me read you the headline from Glenn Greenwald at The Intercept, because it says it all. Washington Post makes history, the first paper to call for prosecution of its own source after accepting a Pulitzer Prize for what he gave them. Isn't that amazing? That is the hypocrisy of the mainstream media. And I've got to say that if you're going to say there's no pardon for Snowden, I think we need to look at what Rand Paul said. He got it exactly right. He goes, well, fine, let's Snowden broke the law, so let's punish him. But let's also punish the people like Michael Hayden at the NSA who broke the law. So no pardon for Michael Hayden either. And no pardon for the Washington Post. Don't hide behind the First Amendment, Washington Post, if you're going to trash the Fourth Amendment, the Fifth Amendment, the Sixth Amendment, okay? They all hang together or they go separately. We ought to do a T-shirt with that. You know, take the old 1776, the Revolutionary War T-shirt, where they showed the different colonies and said, we're either going to hang together or we're going to hang separately. Instead of that, we need to put the individual rights that we have from the Bill of Rights. Not that they gave us the rights. I know that they didn't come from that, but they're recognized by that. And that's something that the Bill of Rights says to the government. These are inherent natural rights, which I know Joe Biden hates the idea of natural rights. He really came after Clarence Thomas in the confirmation hearings. Joe Biden was livid because Clarence Thomas had talked about natural rights. How dare him say that we have rights that don't come from government? But nevertheless, we do. Whether he wants to admit it or not. That was the basis of our country being founded. And the Bill of Rights was there to enshrine the fact that the government couldn't take those away. Not that they're giving them to us, but they can't take them away. And if you're going to say that the Fourth Amendment doesn't matter, Washington Post, well, then guess what? Eventually, you're not going to be able to hold on to the First Amendment either. Same thing with the Second Amendment. They're very selective, aren't they, about what they want to talk about. Stay with us. We'll go right back to the callers when we come back from break. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host. We're going to go to the phone calls here in just a moment. Go to Steve in Canada first. Before we do, real quickly, I thought this was very interesting. On The Hill, there was an editorial from Juan Williams, who is a Fox News contributor. He said that Clinton spoke the truth on deplorables. There you go. Fox News, Juan Williams, thinks that the Fox News viewers are deplorable. All of you who like Donald Trump, all of you who don't want to turn our economy over to a few globalist elitists, all of you who don't like open borders, all of you who don't like the great people replacement, you really are deplorable, says Fox News. And we can see that not only from Juan Williams, but we see it from Megyn Kelly, who's always offended feminists, the angle that she takes. The interesting thing about it, though, was not that we would see Fox News becoming MSNBC, but the fact that Juan Williams would say that Trump supporters are deplorable because Donald Trump has said kind things about Alex Jones. See, it's Alex Jones who is deplorable. Trump is deplorable by association, and so are those people who support Donald Trump. All of us are deplorable, and it goes right back to InfoWars, according to Juan Williams. And, of course, I'm not going to go into all the things that he said is not worth repeating, because all he is doing is repeating the straw man talking points from Rachel Maddow. It's not even worth talking about it at this point. But it is interesting to see Fox News going down that path. And we've seen that happening for quite some time now. It underscores, I think, the fact that we really are in an information war. As I said earlier, the most dangerous thing before us are not the bombs. The most dangerous thing before us is our reaction to that. Are we going to be fooled into giving up more of our liberties for the promise of security that they haven't been able to deliver with this massive surveillance and police state? It hasn't made us any safer, has it? We're even more dangerous. And the real issue are the terrorists that are being brought in by our own government. And when you look at how many of them have to become terrorists, as they point out in Germany, hey, we brought in 500,000 of them. And then they go on to say, well, we think that maybe about 500 of them are jihadis that are really dangerous. They don't really know because they're not vetting anybody. But that's their estimate, 0.1%. So if the people that they're bringing in as migrants and refugees are 99.9% okay, that still means 500 terrorists that they brought in with just 500,000. But they got plans for many more. And it is the great people replacement. That's the key. You have to understand, as we look at these articles where they're talking about this video that's up today, there's no turning back. Swedish TV ad says Swedes must accept multiculturalism. And, of course, the way they're selling this, when you look at the translation, the new country, they say in this video, is about shaping a new future. Being Swedish needs to be about more than skin color and place of birth. It needs to be you, me, and everyone together. Well, that's fine. Except, what is a country? It isn't simply a geographical location. No, a country really is a culture. It's a legal system. And what they're trying to do is bring in people who have a culture and a legal system that is antithetical to everything we've had in the West. They want a theocracy. You have to understand this. Look at Saudi Arabia. Look at the people who are pouring tons of cash into the Hillary Clinton campaign. Look at the people that Hillary Clinton went to speak with, Huma Abedin's mother running a school for girls, a Sharia school for girls in Saudi Arabia, talking about the fact, hey, not all of us in America wear bikinis, okay? shudder to think what that would look like if that were true in Hillary's case. But what she is saying to them, what she's pandering to them is, come to America, just as Alex was saying, come to America, you can replace the people here. See, that's what people in Germany are beginning to understand. If you look in Germany and you see the plummeting polls of Angela Merkel, the people who are pushing back against her said the great people replacement has begun. That's precisely what this is. You and I are either going to change the people in Washington or the people in Washington are going to replace us. That's the bottom line, folks. That's what they want to do. They don't like us because they don't like our legal system. They don't like our individual liberty. They want to run an authoritarian theocracy, and they're bringing in the people to do it. Let's go real quickly to Steve in Canada. Steve, go ahead.
Thank you, David. I'm going to try to make this quick.
Yes.
In regards to the bombings, I've been waiting for something like this to happen, unfortunately. I don't like it, but this is really not that much of a surprise for me. And your segue coming into talking to me I consider myself to be a deplorable. I would like to support Trump somehow north of the border, but not sure how to do it. My other reason for calling in is I'm trying to look for something like what you guys do in Canada, but I can't seem to find very much. The closest I've been able to find is the Rebel Media.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, just a bit nervous here. Anyway,
well,
with the Rebel Media, but they're conservative-leaning, whereas I'm a libertarian, I guess, at heart now, where I'll attack anybody that's coming against me.
Yeah, I'm not sure how to guide you to somebody that does what we do in Canada. But, of course, you could always start something. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host. We're going to go to our callers. We've got three more here holding on the line. And then I want to give you my take on the Snowden movie by Oliver Stone. I agree with Alex. I think it's Oliver Stone's finest work. I'll just tell you that right up front. As a film, I give it two thumbs up. If I had more thumbs, I would give it more thumbs up. But I've only got two thumbs. And as a political information video, it's not a documentary, but it tells you everything. It encapsulates everything that we've been trying to tell people for the longest period of time. It does a great job of informing people. So if you're a listener and you understand what's going on, great. It'll underscore that. It'll fill in some information that was perhaps missing for you in some different areas. But this is a movie that you need to take your friends to who don't think any of this stuff matters. Or take your friends to that think that Ed Snowden needs to be locked up or executed. Take those people to see it. And then have a conversation with them afterwards. See if they really understood it. But that's a great piece, because we can't put all this stuff together in a news broadcast. We can't put all this stuff together on a radio show. We talk about it as it develops over a period of time, and that's a very valuable way for you to see this as it's unfolding. But I've always said in the past that Alex Jones's documentaries were very important, because they would give you, on a particular subject, whether it was 9/11 or whether it was the police state, it would give it to you in a comprehensive format. It would take you down the road, showing you everything that had happened, and do it in detail in one sitting. And that's what the Oliver Stone movie does, but it's not done in a dry documentary format. It's a very well done, very well produced film, and it's something that people will enjoy just as a piece of art, because they do it in a dramatic way. But it is what is happening now. This isn't even something that was important that happened in the past, like the JFK assassination. This is what's happening now. This is our life now. You need to understand what is going on now. This is the problem that I have with people like Gary Johnson. They don't understand the context of the events that are happening right now. They don't even know. He doesn't know what is Aleppo. He doesn't understand the context, the players, what's happening there. How can he respond in a libertarian way even to how to shut this down? He doesn't understand how we're being played. He doesn't get it. People need to understand what is behind all of this. And so it gives you the inside information, because you see Snowden going through this process as somebody who wants to make a difference. He's idealistic, and gradually he sees the corruption, the lies, the tyranny that is involved in this, and he takes you down that path of discovery that Ed Snowden did. And you see what his response was to this. And hopefully, when you see what his response is to it, you'll not only not want to put him in prison, but you'll want to be like him. You'll want to do the right thing. You want to stand up for freedom and individual liberty. Let's go to our callers real quickly. Chris in Washington, because then I want to talk about the wrong way to look at this, and what the Washington Post is doing is absolutely reprehensible. But what else would you expect? What else would you expect from the Washington Post? Let's go to Chris in Washington. Chris?
Yeah, I was just actually going to comment about the mall stabbing,
mm-hmm.
and the off-duty police officer that shot that
yes.
the guy from Somali.
Very important that we understand that it was a guy with a concealed weapon that stopped the carnage there. Yeah. Yes, go ahead.
It was. He was actually the owner of Tactical Advantage LCC, or LLC. He teaches people in concealed carry classes. And he's also a competitor in the USPSA, which is a competitive three-gun sporting event.
Wow. Wow. That was a real blessing that guy was there. And we need more people like that. That's what he's doing, is training people to take responsibility to protect themselves and protect other people as well. That's very important.
Yeah. So I just know a lot of people didn't know that.
Yeah, that's very important. Thank you for pointing that out again. And, you know, when we talk about One of the articles that I've got here about the number of people coming in, almost 100,000 Somali refugees admitted to the U.S. since 9/11. 99.6% of them are Muslim. And, of course, the guy who did the stabbing is a Somali who came in. But it's his father who came in. And I think it's interesting that it's always, it's the second generation. We talk about not being able to vet the people coming in. And the fact that Germany is admitting, okay, probably at least a tenth of a percent of the people coming in are already jihadis. But in most of these cases, the people who are doing this are the second generation people. Their parents do not want to assimilate. They self-ghettoize. And the second generation gets very angry about that because they blame not their parents who don't want to assimilate, who don't want to learn the language, who don't want to embrace the culture, dress the way other people are doing because they want to keep their own separate enclave. So they're isolated. The second generation gets very angry about that. And more often than not, they become the jihadis. That's what we've seen. But as we're talking about people protecting themselves, I remember when you talk about Somali, remember this is Black Hawk Down. Remember that movie? Another movie. Remember what happened there? That was Mogadishu. And what was happening there were the Arabs coming in and coming after black Christians in Somalia. And I talked to a guy who, a friend of mine back in North Carolina, who had been a missionary, and he had been there at the time that that happened. He would walk around with a full-on AR, and he kept that strapped around his shoulder everywhere he went as a missionary. Because he had the position, he had the mindset of a real pastor, of a real sheepdog, okay? Pastors are there to protect the flock, and you have to be able to protect yourself as well, don't you? Just like if you're on an airplane, they tell you, if we have a problem and the gas mask come down, put that gas mask on yourself before you put it on the kids, because you've got to be able to function yourself before you can save other people. So it's there to protect yourself, and you protect yourself so you can protect other people. I remember we talked to the guy in South Africa. His name was Charles van Wyk. He wrote the book about the particular experience that he had. He said he struggled with the idea of whether or not he should, as a Christian, carry a gun to protect himself. And he saw all the violence that was happening in South Africa at the time. And he said, yeah, I think I have a responsibility to protect myself and to protect other people. And on the day that he was visiting a liberal church in a very prosperous area of town, it had been selected by the communists that we worship in this country, the people under Nelson Mandela. They were violent communists. It had been selected by them. We found out this later because they were given amnesty when they talked about the. They were given amnesty, so they then talked about why they selected this church. They said, it's a very liberal church. We knew it'd be mostly or all white. And we knew these people would not be carrying firearms. So they broke in, spraying fully automatic weapons, spraying the crowd with bullets and throwing in hand grenades. Okay, they killed a lot of people right away. But this individual was there. All he had was a pistol with 5 shots. You can see the interview that I had with him. I think it's something like a modern-day David with 5 stones. I can't remember the way we titled it. But he had a pistol, a snub-nosed pistol. And he was all the way across this huge auditorium. And he thought, well, I'll probably never hit him, but maybe I can scare them off. And he got down on his knee and took a shot, and he got one of the guys. And they were surprised. They were surprised that somebody shot back at him. And it stopped the attack. And they started pulling the guys out. He took another couple of shots, didn't hit anybody. And then he thought, well, I'm going to go around, see if I can find another way. He went out the back and came around another way, and these guys were out there. He took another couple of shots at him and hit another couple of guys. They thought there were multiple shooters because he came out from a different angle. And they broke off the attack. They killed, I think it was 50 or 60 people. I don't know how many people they wounded. Because they threw in hand grenades, they had fully automatic weapons. And they said that day they had intended and thought they would be able to kill every single person in that church. And there's about 1,000 people in that church. So the bottom line is, folks, you need to protect yourself, and you need to protect other people. That's what we saw in that mall in Minnesota, as Chris in Washington just pointed out. The guy who was there teaches people how to defend themselves, how to protect other people. See, that's what guns are about. That's what the liberals don't want you to think about when they come after Donald Trump and say, you're threatening violence against Hillary Clinton, when what he was saying was, it's a dangerous thing to be unarmed. She has a lot of people protecting her. Look at the hypocrisy involved. And yet they say, you're making oblique threats against her. It's the same thing that Jim Webb said in the Democrat debate, interestingly enough. He didn't go too far in the Democrat debates. Perhaps they couldn't stand hearing the truth. And they didn't rally around Jim Webb, but he told it like it was. Let's go to Brian and FEMA 9. Brian, thanks for holding.
Good to talk to you, David. You know, this is one of the trusted news sources I go to because so many American news sources are being neutered, gagged like a dog.
Yes.
And so what I'd like to talk about here, of course, we know the Internet's going over to sources unknown in October. And so we don't even know how much time we really have to really talk freely or get freely information according to that source. But what happened at the beginning, like, you know, Friday, Saturday, is the usual game. In other words, we had that attack. In other words, bringing up the actual attack in Syria, the CENTCOM officials said U.S. military was certain about the outcome of the strike. Officials had been watching these forces for a few days thinking they were ISIS. Hmm. And, of course, we know what happened. Later, it was a mistake. Mm-hmm. And now they want to make reparations to pay the soldier's family from American tax dollars. That's ongoing. But then we have the bombings. All of a sudden, within a few hours, we have these bombings. And I went around and talked to people yesterday from church and other places. They had no idea that Syrian forces were attacked by our and Australian warplanes at all. It was news. Mm-hmm. Not one person knew.
Mm-hmm.
And so the Goebbels German dialectic, of course, where you only learn what they want you to learn, is very much in play here.
Yeah, they fight for ISIS. They arm ISIS. They train ISIS. They drop weapons for them. They abandon weapons for them. And then they say, look at this. These weapons that we had there, they just happened to fall into the hands of ISIS. It's by design, and we can see the fact that they're so angry at the Russians because the Russians are actually fighting ISIS. Meanwhile, we fight with ISIS against these other people. We're supposed to believe that we're on the side of the moderate Islamists there, but they won't identify who they're fighting with. We know this from when they talk about the authorization for the use of military force 3 years ago. They were before Congress, and Congress said, well, can you tell us the groups that you're at war with? No, we can't tell you the groups. No, we can't mention the names of the groups that are there. Why? Because they're allied with them. And that's the whole thing. They want to keep even the groups that we are supposedly at this, in this perpetual war of terrorism against, they want to keep them secret. They don't want to mention the names because we're helping those groups. We are ISIS in that area. And that's a key thing that you're pointing out. Yeah. And you know, I got to say that if you want to, let me put in a good word for our new app. We have the new free app from InfoWars. It's absolutely free, folks. You can go to InfoWars.com/app. You can find the links there for your phone, for your Android, or for your Apple phone. It's got a lot of new features. We've had an app for quite some time that has just been the radio show running in rotation. But now this app has a lot of new features. And when you look at what happened, as Brian was talking about, what happened this last weekend, the total cover-up of what was going on in Syria with American forces, and then as we showed earlier today, editing out what Bill Clinton says about Hillary having frequent issues falling, and they completely cut that out. They cut his audio. They do a cutaway to the interviewer nodding his head. So they can cut out the fact that Bill Clinton said frequently. And then what we saw yesterday, Hillary Clinton coming out kind of sleepily talking about the bombings in New York and New Jersey, saying we're going to address that. And then the very first question that comes up says, but Donald Trump is calling these bombings. Oh, he should not be calling these bombings. Yeah, don't call a bombing a bombing. Don't call terrorism terrorism. You know, they wouldn't even call what happened in Minnesota terrorism. They said, there was a guy asking people, he was with a knife, and he's asking people, are you Muslim? He was screaming Allah Akbar as he's slashing at people. But it could be terrorism. We don't know yet. That's the amazing thing. Any other comments, Brian, before we move on to Thomas in Texas?
Yeah, real quick, I also want to put a plug in. I did buy some stuff, some nutraceuticals and the water filtration, because I didn't realize what was in the water. Your body's water is 70% of your water is in your body. And I didn't realize until it tested my water. Literally, there's an attack going on. And I kind of woke up 2009 when I ended up on the terrorist watch list owing $26 million to the United States government by mistake. And that was through OFAC. So mm-hmm. I've been in court now for 6 years, won twice the Supreme Court. America, do your due diligence. Get your news sources. Get the truth. And believe in God. Believe in the name of Jesus Christ. Repent and be baptized in the name of Christ and receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Absolutely. Amen to that. And, you know, but it's just, as Rachel Maddow says, it's just a conspiracy theory that you should have clean water, clean air, that you should get water and air filters. You know, don't bother with that. Just go with what they have your best interest at heart. And, you know, it's just science. Science is in play here, so no need to worry about your own health. Just go out and breathe deeply. Don't worry about the air quality. Don't worry about what's in your water. Don't worry about the runoff of pharmaceuticals that aren't filtered out in your city water supply. Don't worry about the glyphosate that gets put into the rural wells as you pull the stuff in. And don't worry about the stuff that they spend millions of dollars to dump into your water that is toxic, that takes down your IQ. Don't worry about fluoride. Don't worry about that. That's just fine. That, you know, nothing at all to see. Just move on. Let's go to Thomas in Texas. Thomas.
Yeah, and good luck finding a food that doesn't have a bunch of poison in it. I was just trying to call in and ask. I mean, you know, I hear the show all the time, but what exactly do we do to fight the New World Order? You know, like what can I as an individual actually do to actively participate and make a difference in that?
Well, as I said before, I think the most important thing is information, because taking a look at Bill Ayers as a case in point, this is a guy who went around, he did some bombing campaigns, some minor bombing campaigns, he hurt some people, but he didn't have that big of an effect. As a matter of fact, it backfired on him. Where he really became dangerous was when he got involved in education. That's what he did in Chicago, and that's part of it was mentoring Barack Obama there, but where he got really dangerous was getting involved in education and changing the government schools to indoctrinate children into the kind of socialism that he wanted. Remember that white skin privilege originated with the group that he was in, okay? Students for Democratic Society, the Weather Underground, they were the people who created white skin privilege. Why? Because Marxists and socialists who want to create a revolution, who want to create unrest, they always have to pit people against each other. Now, in Europe, they did that with economic classes. Here in America, that didn't work too well for them because everybody was aspirational. They thought they could move up and down the economic ladder. So that wasn't going to work for them. So they had to do it with racism. And that's what Bill Ayers and others have been doing. So the point is, it's the information war. What these people are doing now in terms of using political correctness to get us to accept the refugees, to accept the open borders, to accept globalism. That is the real struggle, and you have to educate yourself. Take people to go see the Snowden movie. We'll talk about that when we come back. That's a very important thing. Educate people with entertainment. That's, you know, I just had the last caller asking me what you could do. What's the best way to fight for liberty? I think the key thing is to know the truth, to educate yourself, to educate others. And you know, we hear all the time, knowledge is power. And the truth will set you free. You know, one of the things that's been very freeing in the last week or so is what we have seen the mainstream media do to manipulate the news. And, of course, we've been pointing that out with bright red flags and neon signs showing you over and over again the way the media is manipulating what is going on, putting words in Donald Trump's mouth or taking them out of the mouth of Hillary Clinton and Bill Clinton. The way they have rigged this, hiding her collapse at first until it no longer could be hidden. And, of course, it couldn't be hidden because we're pointing at it. Now, if you want to get this information and be able to spread it to other people, get InfoWars new app. That's at InfoWars.com/app. You'll see that we have really upgraded this free app that we have for, we've had an app that was free for quite some time where you could listen to the radio broadcast, but it is far more extensive than this. Every story is there organized by category, so you can find the information you want when you want it, and you can share it with other people. So there's much more content that's going to be available on the InfoWars app, and it's very, very key. One of the things I think that is very important, as I was going to talk about the Snowden movie by Oliver Stone, it's an excellent movie in its own right. It's very entertaining, and it is very educational without having to sit through a documentary. I know many people, once they hear it's a documentary, many of my friends just say, I'm not going to go. I'm not going to see it. A documentary is a great way for people to get the full context of events. to see a pattern, to see the timeline of events, to have a full exposition of what's going on. But most people won't do that. Now, it's important for people to see this Snowden movie. And let me give you an example why. Okay, this is the Foundation for Economic Education talking about the movie, talking about what they learned about Snowden. They said, you know, their observation was that everybody else went along with what was happening. They didn't ask questions. They didn't question what was going on. It was purely abstract to them. And they said, surely they would look at this and see no real escape. You could only adapt, enjoy the power, take the money, and then someday die. They said, throughout all of this, Snowden was scared, but he was never indecisive. He was unimpressed by the machinery that was around him. He saw it not as his master and not even as his equal. He saw it all as beatable. He knew that what he was doing was right, and he did it all because, against all odds, he thought he could make a difference. See? That's why the establishment thinks he needs to be punished, just like Thomas Drake or William Binney, people who had also done this, who had blown a whistle. And you never know when it's finally going to dawn on people. And that's it. These people, like William Binney and Thomas Drake, who were NSA employees as well, had gone through all the channels. They had gone to Congress, and Congress just shut them down because Congress is a part of this criminal action. And so he saw that, and he knew what would happen to him, and that's why he did it the way that he did it. And they go on and point out a key point in the movie where he's being interviewed by the CIA at that point in time. And the person who's interviewing him quotes a line to see what he has to say. They ask him different questions to try to get his worldview. And the interviewer quotes a line from Atlas Shrugged, "One man can stop the motor of the world." Snowden hears that, and he agrees. And you can see the consternation in the face of the guy who asked him that. Now, tonight we're going to talk about it because I don't have any time left. We're going to talk about what the Washington Post did. The Washington Post said no pardon for Edward Snowden. I think it is one of the most cowardly, deceitful things I have ever seen. People who have used his information, and as Glenn Greenwald points out, some of the information that they complain about is being damaging was the information that they put out. We're going to talk about that tonight on the Nightly News, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern. Join us then.